That's Nick. Nick, you sent me that, didn't you? Good. Thank you, Nick. I got your text, so I guess we're okay. That means you're not listening on the radio. You're on the internet connection. Audio as well? Good. I'm assuming that's the case.
We have 1 minute.
Thank you. 1 minute. And I got Phil, too. I got your messages, guys. Thank you. I got Phil at Brady's. I got Nick at the newspaper. The connection must be okay. All right, guys, let's go. I got you. We're ready to go. That was 38. That'd be 28. This is it. This is it. For all the marbles, in about 2.5 hours, it'll be all over except the shouting, but there's going to be an awful lot of shouting in the next couple of hours. I guarantee a very, very, very pleasant good evening to you once again, everybody. Chris Needham live on Magic 95. And we're also hooked up on the internet webcast. So we're very, very happy to have a bunch of you listening. We're live at the Washington Avenue Armory in Albany, New York. And I open my broadcast with "This is it." And that is the case. It is all over after tonight. That was a negative maybe when we found out about it last Saturday night. But we've learned in the last week or so that it's actually quite a positive. The CBA. A week ago Saturday night, we had the announcement that the CBA would shorten and abbreviate our 2009 season. And just have the Cavs come to Albany and play two regular season games Monday and Tuesday night against the Patroons right here in the Washington Avenue Armory, then stay in town. That would help with expenses and everything. And just have a best 2 out of 3 CBA finals. And it has been exciting. It has been something else. This is it, though. That's what I said. The final game is tonight. In 2 hours, we'll have a 2009 CBA champion. The Cavs won it last year as we eliminated Yakima in the playoffs, then had a 5-game series with Minot and won a great ring, and everybody proud of the Cavs. Well, can we do it again, and would it be tainted? I don't think so. I mean, you know, obviously it's a short season. The Cavs are 13-3 overall. We've just played 16 games. Albany 14-8 overall. Some of those were against ABA competition, but it's still a battle of the two best teams in the league. I think our team this year is as good, if not better. I think we're deeper this year than we were last year. So getting a championship, would the guys celebrate tonight? John Zelpst across the way, would he celebrate? I guarantee you, he's fired up. Mike Brown, one of our owners, He's across the way. He's pumped up. There are a bunch of you with Phil Kennedy and probably Hossein Moines over there as well. A bunch of you, 50 or so last night, I'm sure. We're over at Brady's in Lawton, and we are aware. We've just gotten text messages that we're hooked up, and we have a good signal over there with them watching. If you can get to Brady's, they're having a watch party over there. Nick Livingston just texted me that they've got the internet live clear at the newspaper. Nick's done a great job this year, and the Lawton Constitution has done a superb job in covering the Cavs and being honest about everything and letting everybody know what's going on. John Zelps and I had a good discussion before the game tonight about the future of the CBA, the future of the Cavs. The Cavs will play basketball next year, folks. I guarantee you, the Cavs are going to play basketball next year. We don't know what's going to happen, but let's just end this situation with a championship, and that's the matter at hand. So let's go to the CBA Finals on Thursday night. The Cavs in one of the most exciting games we've ever seen. Cavs beat Albany right here, 125-115. DeAnthony Bowden with 26 points. I got to say Bowden. I've been watching the TV up here, and every night they're showing the highlights, and they're going Bowden. DeAnthony Bowden had 62 points. On Thursday night, we won it 125-115, then could have closed it out and won the title last night. We were down late in the ball game by 6, outscored them 8-2 late to tie it at 104. We go into overtime, and the Cavs had 2 missed opportunities late in the contest and lost in overtime to Albany last night, 111-109. And so that sets up a deciding Game 3 here tonight. It'll start in about 10 minutes. On the season series, the Cavs have beaten Albany 6-2, but we beat them 4 straight to start our season when they were really a bad basketball team. They brought in 4 new players after that, and they became one of the best teams in the league. Harvey Thomas averaging 24 points a game. Gabe Freeman came in, averaging 15 a game. Backup point guard Daryl Hill came in, but as you'll hear from Michael Ray Richardson on my pre-recorded pregame show, he thinks the key to their team is Sean Fountain. And Fountain played over 50 minutes last night, and he wants to go at Sean Fountain tonight. Now, I had a very detailed talk in the hotel this morning with Michael Ray Richardson. We talked about zone defense. DeAnthony Bowden, when we got out of the van, went to the hotel last night, D-Bow, who, by the way, was hurt last night. His knee was all banged up. That's why he didn't play that well. But he was saying those chickens, he was mad at Albany because they played a zone. And he said, you know, they didn't match up well, and they were playing a zone. Well, Michael realized it, and the zone was what kept us away from some of our interior activity late. Well, it's legal. You can do it. There are ways you can combat it. So Michael and I talked about the zone this morning, talked about what he wants to do. I'll ask him about it on the pregame show, his strategy about going at Sean Fountain, things like that. So it'll be a fascinating contest, a fascinating matchup. As we said, the Cavs in the season series have a 6-2 advantage, but since we've been up here in the 2 meaningless games, really Monday and Tuesday, that we're just getting ready for the playoffs, they won one, the Cavs won one. Now in the playoffs, the Cavs won the first one, Albany has won the second one, even though with those 2 late game shots last night, one for Eddie Smith going down the lane, one for Brandon Dean going down the lane, the guys were just irate that the officials weren't calling fouls, and you can't blame it on officiating, though. Forget it. It is just a game tonight. Whoever wins the CBA title, and the Cavs are pumped up. In that game last night, the Cavs lose it 111-109 in overtime. We shot 47%. Albany was at 49%. The Cavs, 20 of 25 from the free throw line, 80%, one of our best efforts of the year. A great job. They were 26 of 36 from the line. Here it was a 2-point overtime game. They got 36 free throws. The Cavs got 25. You can scream about that, but you just say forget about it. It is what it is. Let's play ball tonight. They're 26 of 36. Albany was 72%. Albany was 11 of 21 from 3-point range. That's their bread and butter. Did you hear that stat? Albany last night, 11 of 21 from 3-point range. 52% from 3-point range is mind-boggling. Cavs were 5 of 13 from 3-point range, 39%. That's not bad. That's about normal. But we only get 5 threes. They get 11 threes. That obviously is a 6-point difference in a 2-point game. The Cavs won the rebounding battle, 43-42. Assist-to-turnover ratio, not a big factor for either team. Albany, 17 assists, 19 turnovers last night. The Cavs, 13 assists, 16 turnovers. So that's the setup. That's your situation on the pregame show brought to you by Anna's German Quick Stop. Before the game or any time, stop by Anna's German Quick Stop at the corner of Sheridan Road and D Avenue, serving great food with friendly service and daily specials. Stop in today for a taste of Germany. Anna's German Quick Stop. Our pregame interview with Michael Ray Richardson. On the immediate horizon, we have set up the situation for you. The Cavs against the Patroons. The crowd tonight. Now I've been doing my homework. I haven't been looking around. I start to look around the arena. We will not have the crowd they had last night. Last night was a big Saturday night. A lot of kids were here. There were some police league. They brought in some kids and everything. But they'll have 1,000 here tonight, 1,100. Now, I did talk to John Zelbst and Mike Brown both before the game tonight, just a minute ago. And they said, and you know, I've got my headphones on, I'm broadcasting, I can't pay attention to this. They said the crowd that was big last night, and they really were, there were about 2,000 people here, the official announcement, 1,890. But Mike Brown said they didn't make any noise. They weren't as loud. He said 500 of our fans in the Great Plains Coliseum make twice as much noise. So you Lawton fans, I guarantee you, your reputation precedes you. So we'll see what happens. Tonight they'll have anywhere from 900 to 1,000. Will they make much noise? This is it. It's the final game of the regular CBA season. Now, therefore, the pressure is on, right? The pressure. Boy, I'm telling you, it's the final. I'm building this up. I'm lying. Michael Ray Richardson, are the Cavs feeling pressure? Are you feeling pressure? We've got to play in their arena. Yeah, that's not fair. The CBA had to do it this way. We were in town. Instead of having to spend more money for travel, instead of having to spend more money on a lease in Lawton, I mean, they own their arena up here, all that stuff. So we've got to play the championship game in their arena. Sure, that's not fair. We know that. But it just is what it is. You got to do it. And so pressure, is there pressure on the Lawton-Fort Sill Cavs? Michael Ray Richardson?
If you look at the whole picture here, it ain't no pressure on us. What we need to do is come in here and do what we need to do. Even as bad as the officiating was, we still should have won the game. We missed two or three easy ones, and that was it. You know, that's part of basketball. I think that they're under more pressure than we are.
And I made the point that when it comes down to a situation, tight game, late changes, things like that, And I like Derek, you like Derek, but I think you can out-coach him. I think we got better players, things like that, but you're right. A couple of tip-ins late, two drives down the lane that were no calls, and yet you have to accept that in basketball.
I mean, especially with a league like this where it was set up, which is unheard of, to have three games here on a home floor. So it puts you in a situation where your back's already against the wall. But, you know, we came out, we won game one, they won game two, and then now we have to win game three.
Attitude in the shoot-around today, guys angry or just dedicated, what?
We didn't even have a shoot-around. Well, what I did was, you know, we played hard, the game went into overtime, and what I tried to do was just keep them away from it. For about 24 hours.
And that's good. Get their mind right. And I know these guys want it. They respect you. I'm not being too maudlin about it. They respect you. They love you. They want it for you. They want it for themselves.
They want it for themselves. They want it for me. But also, the most important, they want it for the city of Lawton, Oklahoma. And I, you know, owners who have stuck this thing out and tried to make this thing work. And unfortunately, it came to this, so we want to win it for our owners.
Similar situation. Fairly high scoring quarters one and two, 60 to 50 at halftime, and then more of a half court, Michael Richardson type, slow it down, bring it up the floor, tempo in the second half. Yet this morning when you and I talked, you said still we took too many outside shots.
Still. On someone else's floor, you can't take that many jump shots. It's just the percentages are not with you. What you want to do is you want to grind it into the paint, get into the penalty, which we wasn't in the penalty the second half of yesterday at all. We got to get in the penalty.
D'Anthony Bowden and I talked after the game last night. He was real upset, almost called them chicken in the fact that they were playing zone, and that prevented us from going inside the way that we wanted to, spreading the floor, things like that. But obviously, you've got answers for that.
I hope he plays his own tonight, because I guarantee you we will get him out of it real quick.
And how do you do that?
Just overload one side and put one of my shooters in the middle. I mean, I'm prepared for it.
And Sean Daniels, no one on their squad has shown that they have the defensive ability to stop Sean if he dedicates himself to going to the hole.
Well, he's dedicated. He wants to win, and he will definitely get his chances.
Well, 17 for D'Anthony Bowden in the first quarter. He wasn't on his way to a 62, but then he got banged up a little bit. You could tell that he was struggling a little second half.
Yeah, but, you know, look, Sean Fountain plays 53 minutes. He plays 25. He's a little more fresher than, you know, he is.
And I know that's what you want to do, go after Sean. As a matter of fact, people would say with their 24 points a game and Harvey Thomas and then Freeman, that those are the keys. As far as you're concerned, Sean Fountain's the key.
He's the key. He's the engine to the car. If the car ain't running, if the engine ain't running, the car ain't running. So you got to slow down the engine.
You got to take the coal away, don't you?
You got to take it away. And there is no more tomorrow. It's either who wants it the most. All right. And right now, we want it.
Who wants it the most? Who wants it the most? That's Michael Ray Richardson, our pre-recorded pre-game chat with the veteran coach of your Lawton-Fort Sill Cavs. I'm going to miss it. I just love talking to Michael Ray. I love hanging with these guys. We've been up here for a whole week, five games. It's fun. They're just about ready for the national anthem. Let's take a two-minute break. We'll pause for 2 minutes on our pregame show. Then we're back for the CBA championship game. Back in 2 minutes. Cavs coming your way on Magic 95.
Golly. My goodness.
10 seconds, Chris.
I got you. Thank you. Our timing is absolutely perfect as we come back live. We're just about set for the introduction of the starting lineups, and we didn't want to, on our radio broadcast, be talking or have commercials during the singing of the national anthem. A young man here just brought the house down. I mean, he couldn't be 7, 8, 9 years old. And what a beautiful rendition of the national anthem. So we're ready to go. The Cavs will be introduced, and of course, our normal starters will come on the floor for Michael Ray Richardson, D'Anthony Bowden, the 6'1 guard out of Creighton, and Brandon Dean, the 6'2 guard out of Arkansas. Bowden and Dean have been a mainstay as our starters on the guard line. Tim Ellis, 6'4", 190 out of Kansas State, and Elvin Mims, the 6'5", 215-pounder out of southern Mississippi. He's a native of Florida. Sat and talked with him in the hotel the other night. Elvin Mims, a very, very quiet guy, just sort of hangs to himself. Guys love him, everything, but he just he's not one of the most outward-speaking guys, but boy, what a season he's been having. Averaging 11 points a game, an 89% shooter from the line. He had 14 points, 9 rebounds last night. Late in the game, had one of the biggest blocks I've ever seen in crunch time, late on Freeman, but I thought that was going to lead to our victory, but we lose it. 104-104, we were tied at the end of regulation and then went into overtime. So those are the guards, De'Anthony Bowden, Brandon Dean, and then our forwards, of course, the Yakima connection. They both played at Yakima last year, Tim Ellis and Elvin Mims, and the man in the middle, the big guy, Sean Daniels, 6'6", 270, out of Utah State. Sean had a wonderful game last night, his best scoring game ever as a Cav. Sean Daniels last night had 29 points, 8 rebounds. He was 14 of 22 from the floor. Sean was just 1 of 5 from the free throw line. And you heard my interview with Michael Ray Richardson that a major, major factor is going to be getting Sean going, getting him inside. There is no one on the Albany team, absolutely no one on the Albany team that can defend against Sean Daniels one-on-one inside. We laughed last night about how they put Scotty Wilson on him midway through the third quarter, and Sean went to the glass, layup, good. They came down the floor again. Sean, Scotty Wilson was guarding him. Sean made a spin move, little baby hook. It went down. Next time we came down the floor, Sean on Scotty Wilson. He turned and went with a left-handed little finger roll. It went down. I mean, I kept saying, is Derek Rowland watching this, their coach? How can he let this happen? 7 straight times, Sean was guarded one-on-one. We played ISO basketball, and he just scored on Scotty Wilson. 6 out of 7 trips down the floor. Finally, they switched off and put Gabe Freeman on him. Sean, I talked to him after the game in the hotel last night, and he went, yeah, I remember that. They had that guy on. And then they put old Flat Top back on me again. He called Gabe Freeman old Flat Top, but I don't know what they're going to do. But I tell you what the Cavs are going to do right off the bat. We'll go to Sean Daniels inside right off from the get-go. We got to play defense. Michael Ray Richardson talked about going right at Sean Fountain, their point guard. He played 52 minutes last night. He's going to be tired. We got to put pressure on him. De'Anthony Bowden is going to be better. He had 17 points in the first quarter last night, but then tumbled to the floor. It was a pretty severe knee bruise, and he just didn't feel right the rest of the way. So De'Anthony Bowden's last 3 games are 2 points, 62 points, and 20 points last night. D-Bow was 7 of 7 from the free throw line. Remember, as a team, we were 20 of 25 from the line. That was a big factor. Jumping center, Cavs win the tip, but De'Anthony Bowden can't catch up to the basketball. It was tipped toward D-Bow, and now the officials say both players touched it. It went out of bounds, so we'll have a re-jump. Clock did not start, so we are just about ready to go. Another jump ball. Sean Fountain, Harvey Thomas, Neely, Gabe Freeman, and J.J. Sullinger starting for Albany. Sullinger did not start last night. Tip controlled by the Cavs. De'Anthony Bowden with the basketball. Cavs going from right to left as I look at it. I am not sure what the camera angle is on our webcast, but anyway, the Cavs in the road blue. We've got Ellis working inside. Head fake shoot. We were trying to get a foul call right off the bat. Ellis doesn't get the shot to go. Neely gets their rebound, and they just were killing us on the offensive glass. Neely run the length of the floor, lay it up, miss it! There's Elvin Mims with a great rebound. That's what I told you. So both teams have missed open looks. Both teams to start the contest are 0 of 1 from the floor. De'Anthony Bowden working it to Sean Daniels. Backing in. We're going to isolate the entire left side for Sean. Backing, wheeling, spinning, dumping it off in the lane for Ellis. Bank shot, Tim. He didn't bank it. Yes, he tried. He tried to bank it off the glass, but it was too strong. Sean Fountain has it for Albany, going from left to right. Neither team has scored. We have played 1 minute in the ballgame. They have Neely, baseline right, a whistle away from the activity, or a whistle at the basketball. That's going to be Sean Daniels. Did they call the foul on Sean? They did indeed. It'll be a side out with a 14-second reset of the shot clock for Albany. The trigger man is Neely to Sean Fountain. Harvey Thomas will try to play more tonight. He got into a little early foul difficulty. Fountain, a long jumper. It's going to be off. That's a weak side rebound for Brandon Dean. Brandon Dean last night had 23 points and 7 rebounds. Nobody has scored yet. We played a minute 15. We isolate DeAnthony Bowden on the left wing. He'll try to work into the paint. What a spin move and a layup and a score for DeBowd. DeBowd. DeAnthony Bowden gives the Cavs the early lead at 2-0. What a spin move. And DeAnthony Bowden, with a minute and a half gone in the contest, gives the Cavs the early lead. Harvey Thomas, long jumper, Albany, head of the lane. Got it, gets a two. Harvey Thomas is their big stud. We're tied at two. Harvey Thomas averages 24 a game. He had 19 points, 12 rebounds. He was 6 of 10 from the floor. Harvey Thomas, last night. We're going to play that two-man game on the left of the block again. Now left low block. It is Sean Daniels backing in, guarded by Harvey Thomas. And they call the offensive foul on Sean. That is the first. I want to make sure they didn't call a foul on that defensive trip last time. We sure don't want Sean Daniels to have two early fouls, no. And the scoreboard does not put up the fouls on a cumulative total as we would like them to do. Harvey Thomas, high left wing, give it to Freeman, pop a jumper, miss it. Cavs get the rebound. We've got to do a better job rebounding. DeAnthony Bowden coming up the left sideline. Cavs don't have numbers. This is Brandon Dean. Run the lane, Brandon. Back to DeBow. Fake a three. 9:45 left. He'll run. Shot blocked out of bounds by Harvey Thomas. Perpetually, we're getting mismatches where they switch. And Harvey Thomas has been guarding DeAnthony Bowden a bunch. Harvey Thomas fouled DeBow. Knocked it out of bounds, but then a late call. They called a foul on Harvey Thomas, so that's good. He got two early fouls last night and sat the majority of the first half. Came in and played well late, but then he ended up with six personal fouls. Bowden, free throw, got it. So in a 2-2 tie, DeAnthony Bowden driving down the right of the lane, fouled by Harvey Thomas. DeBow gets the first free throw to go. The 6-1 performer out of Creighton, a 74% shooter from the line, was 7 of 7 from the line last night. Another free throw. DeBow got it. He's got 4 points. All of our points. Cavs lead 4-2. In his 62-point game, he was 14 of 16 from the line. Then last night, he was 7 of 7. Tonight, he's 2 of 2. Harvey Thomas, head of the lane, jumper, got it. I tell you, Harvey Thomas, Michael Ray told me, we're not going to worry as much about him as we are of Sean Fountain, but Harvey Thomas will kill you. Again, Sean's going to back in. Now he fronts Harvey Thomas, goes to the bucket. Finger roll, does not go for Sean. We've got to get Sean untracked offensively. Last night, Sean Daniels was 14 of 22 from the floor. Outside jumper, high left wing, does not go for Rod Neely. Cavs get a rebound, they call a foul on Freeman. So Neely just shot. It was Brandon Dean getting the rebound on the strong side. Came back toward the shooter. And then Gabe Freeman with really a brain-dead foul there. You don't need that foul. We played 3 minutes in the ball game. Your score is DeAnthony Bowden 4, Harvey Thomas 4. DeAnthony Bowden, high left wing, free throw line extended. Fake left, go right, run the lane again. Guarded by Thomas, lay it up, score. DeBow has 6. And the Cavs lead it 6-4. DeAnthony Bowden has all 6 of our points. Harvey Thomas has all 4 of theirs. Sean almost makes a steal. Neely has the loose ball. Pick it up, shoot, miss. Elvin Mims with the rebound. Cavs have the ball in a 2-point lead. Nobody has led by more than 2. 8:25 left, first quarter. DeAnthony Bowden already has 6 points. Remember, 2 nights ago he had 62. This is DeAnthony Bowden running the lane. Ball tipped free. It is loose, still loose, still loose. Tim Ellis picks it up to Sean. Lay it up, Sean. Missed another layup. Sean is having trouble finishing. Loose ball. Sean picks it up. Gets it to DeAnthony Bowden. Baseline left corner. We get a new shot clock. Bowden, crossover dribble. Run. Pop a jumper. Does not get it. Nice rebound, Tim Ellis. Cavs are getting offensive boards. Slow down. Reestablish an offensive set. We played 4 minutes. Lawton-Fort Sill. Your Cavs lead at 6-4. Brandon Dean to Bowden. Fake a three. Now take the three. Does not get it. What a rebound. Mims, reverse layup. Elvin Mims. Elvin Mims with a reverse layup, and the Cavs are up 8-4. Fountain runs for them. Shoot, miss it. Elvin Mims, a defensive rebound. So Elvin Mims got a great offensive rebound, a put back for the Cavs. We lead 8-4 at the other end. Fountain shoots, misses. Elvin Mims gets the defensive rebound. Bowden again, left low block, finds Sean. Backing in on Harvey Thomas. We're going to go to the glass again. He lays it up. Got it this time. Sean Daniels. Cavs are up 10-4. 7:15 left. in your first quarter. Freeman cuts between a double, gets an easy layup. Gabe Freeman, who had an amazing game last night, makes it a 10-6 Cavs advantage. We had scored six straight points. Brandon Dean, a three from the right wing. Got it! Brandon Dean just hit a triple for the good guys, and the Cavs are up 13-6. This is the CBA Finals. Whoever wins this gets a ring. Sean Fountain, high right. They play a two-man game on that right wing with Neely. Neely fouled by Tim Ellis. 6:41 left in the first quarter. Lawton-Fort Sill with the 13-6 advantage. DeAnthony Bowden already with 6 points. Brandon Dean has hit a triple. Elvin Mims has a great offensive putback. Sean Daniels with a driving layup. Four Cavs have already scored. Two for Sean, two for Elvin, three for Brandon, six for Bowden. 13-6 the advantage. Four for Harvey Thomas and two for Gabe Freeman for Albany. They have 15 to shoot. Neely, loop it low, baseline right for J.J. Sullinger, the former Ohio State performer. At the head of the lane, find Freeman, fake a three, dribble closer, kick it left, Harvey Thomas, head of the lane, Fountain, high right, Sullinger a three. Got it. 13-9, they live and die by the threes. Albany had 11 threes last night. The Cavs had only 5 threes. 6:15 left. First quarter, Cavs are up 13-9. We're isolating the right side for Brandon Dean. Pop a jumper, does not go. We didn't crash the boards. No offensive rebounding there. They had the defensive rebound for Sullinger. He'll take another three. Got this one. Holy smoke. Well, we had established, the Cavs had established a pretty good lead at 13-6. They get back-to-back threes for Sullinger. It's a one-point game. DeAnthony Bowden, low left side, finding Sean again. They're going to try to put Sullinger on Sean. Sean backing, wheeling, shooting, fouled. Ball goes down. Sean got the roll. Sean Daniels got the roll, and he was fouled. What did I tell you on the pregame show? They have nobody to guard Sean Daniels backing down, just like Shaquille O'Neal. Nobody can get him when he just backs down, has the little baby hook. That's what happens here. Nobody can guard Sean Daniels backing down for that baby hook. Put it on the board. They haven't put the basket on the board yet. 6, 9, 10, 11. It should be 15-12. Did they not give him the bucket there? It went down. Here's a timeout. I'm not sure if it's a full timeout. We'll keep our broadcast right here. Hey, Adventure Travel does the job for you. Listen to these great specials from Adventure Travel. We've got a Carnival cruise to Alaska, June 3rd. And from Anchorage, the Carnival cruise will go to Sitka, Juneau, Skagway, and Ketchikan. That's $399, double occupancy. There's a Adventure Travel Vegas trip leaving Oklahoma City February 24th for 3 nights at the Luxor. Round trip airfare and the 3 nights at the Luxor for $330, double occupancy. I keep looking as I'm reading this commercial, and now they finally put those points on the board. Why did they take so long to put that bucket was good. Cavs are up 15-12. We've got a departure from Dallas-Fort Worth, 4 nights to Acapulco, April 13th. The Fiesta Americana Villas in Acapulco, $630 per person for that 4-night trip to Acapulco. That's great. Central Mall and the PX Mall, where you'll find Adventure Travel right next to the Cavalry office. Adventure Travel, the 800 number, 800-540-9030. Sean got the bucket to go, and he was fouled. Cavs up 15-12. Here's the free throw. Got it. Sean Daniels got the free throw to go. And the Cavs have a 16-12 advantage. Our largest lead had been 7 at 13-6. 5.5 left first quarter. Sean Fountain, dogged by DeAnthony Bowden, finds Sullinger. He's hit back-to-back threes. Sullinger high right with just a handoff to Neely. Sullinger gets it back, another three. Misses this, and what a great rebound for Elvin Mims. Elvin Mims has obviously dedicated himself to owning the glass tonight. Windex City. Elvin Mims, boy, he's had 4 great rebounds already. DeAnthony Bowden, high left, pop a three, D-bow. It does not go. Hits the heel, goes over the backboard. Remember on Thursday night when DeAnthony Bowden had that amazing game of 62, an all-time CBA Finals record. He was 10 of 11 from three-point range. I read that. I still can't believe it. DeAnthony Bowden was 10 of 11 from three-point range. He just missed that. They're running. Freeman, coast to coast. Lay it up. Miss it. Sean, another good defensive rebound. Cavs are doing a job on the glass. Michael Ray in the pregame show told me we've got to control the rebounding tonight. Cavs have the ball in a 16-12 advantage. Sean Daniels backing on Harvey Thomas. We're isolating again. Sean, take Harvey Thomas to the glass. Backing, spinning. Hook shot. Does not go. Harvey Thomas gets the rebound. Up the left sideline, they've got the outlet to Sullinger. Run, put it up, miss it. Elvin Mims gets another rebound. He tipped it to Brandon Dean. Here come the Cavs. D-Bout, run baseline right. He was out of bounds when he caught the ball. DeAnthony Bowden was out of bounds on the right sideline when he caught the ball. 4:25 left, first quarter. Lawton-Fort Sill with the 16-12 advantage. Cavs are playing well. Harvey Thomas, their leading scorer, will bring it into the forecourt himself. Near the right sideline, Harvey Thomas, high right wing, guarded by Elvin Mims. Cross court, Freeman in the lane. 17-footer. Does not go. Tip up does go for Sullinger. Well, that's what's amazing about basketball. Sullinger in the entire game had just 6 points last night. He already has 8 in this game. For the Cavs, it's Bowden, run the lane. D-Bow, kick it to Brandon Dean at the head of the lane. Get a pick from Sean, go down the right of the lane. Brandon Dean. Stutter step, jab step, put up a 5-foot jumper, got it. Brandon Dean has 5 points. We're doing a good job working inside, and the Cavs are up 18-14. Albany loves to respond quickly. We're falling back better defensively tonight. This is Neely, fouled by Ellis. They're going to call it tightly. We're going to have to watch for foul difficulty tonight. I think Michael's going to have to sub some quickly. You don't want to get anybody into any foul difficulty, obviously. Side out, 15 to shoot, right sideline. Fountain will bring it to Harvey Thomas. Albany with the ball. The Cavs are winning 18-14, 3.5 left first quarter. Sullinger dump it off inside on the baseline. Ball tipped free, loose in the lane. DeAnthony Bowden comes out of there. We've got a 3-on-2 break. Ball kicked out of bounds. Had a 3-on-2 break. Bounce pass, DeAnthony Bowden to Brandon. It was kicked out of bounds by Freeman. Cavs made that trip up the floor in 3 seconds because there's 21 seconds left on the shot clock. Sometimes they're slow pulling the trigger on that shot clock. Cavs have a side out, right sideline. It went out of bounds on the baseline. Why do we have a right? Well, because of the kick. It was a kick ball. This is DeAnthony Bowden, high right. Again, guarded by Harvey Thomas. I just can't believe that. Harvey Thomas guarding D-Bow. Stutter step, run the lane. Jumper doesn't go. Nice defense by Freeman. And Harvey Thomas, but Freeman caught the ball and dropped it out of bounds. Caught the ball, dropped it out of bounds. We don't get a reset of the shot clock. Do the guys know we have only 6 to shoot? The Cavs, now we do get a reset. I was right. For some reason. Oh, no, they don't reset it. They say that it didn't hit the rim. We have only, well, now they reset it. All right, only 6 to shoot. Cavs have to bring it in. Only 6 to shoot. Bring it to Bowden. Stutter step. D-Bow in the lane. 2 seconds left. Hurry, Tim Ellis, hook shot. No, we did not get the shot off in time. Now, there was a little controversy there. Did they reset the shot clock to 24? They did. Then they put it back to 6, and the shot clock caught the Cavs. 3 minutes exactly left. Quarter number one. We're at the Washington Avenue Armory, Albany, New York. The Cavs are up 18-14. Sullinger, another 3, left baseline corner, misses. Rebound comes to Tim Ellis. Bring it up the floor slowly. Control tempo, find Brandon Dean. Brandon Dean, way high on the right side. Running clock. We do not want to get in a running game with these guys. Brandon, loop it to Sean. Sean Daniels getting a pick. Setting the pick for Brandon Dean. Brandon running off of it to the right side. Pick and roll move to Sean. Lay it up, score. That's the patented pick and roll move. Sean high at the head of the lane on the right side. Picked it for Brandon. Brandon with the return pass on the pick and roll. Sean has 7 points. Cavs are up 20-14. Cavs by 6. J.J. Sullinger cross court to Fountain. Fountain fake right, go left, crossover dribble, go down the right baseline area, throws it out of bounds. Cavs, good defense. Good defense, Cavs. That's Cavalry basketball. Timeout, 2:06 left. We take a 60-second break. 2:06 remaining. Quarter number one. Cavs are playing well. The major key is Albany has only 14 points. We have played 10 minutes of basketball, and Albany has only 14 points. That's the major, major key. We're playing good defense. 20-14, back in a minute. Cavs coming your way right here on Magic 95.
Ten seconds.
Thank you. I am ready. Thank you. Your early score in this contest was DeAnthony Bowden 6, Harvey Thomas 4. The first 10 points of the game. DeAnthony Bowden had 6 for the Cavs, all of our 6 points, and Harvey Thomas had all of their 4. Since then, Brandon Dean has 5. But DeAnthony hadn't scored, so he still has 6. Brandon Dean has 5. Sean Daniels now has 7 points. And Elvin Mims a deuce on an offensive putback, and Elvin's doing a great job on the boards. They've got the 4 for Harvey Thomas, 8 now for J.J. Sullinger, and 2 for Gabe Freeman. Cavs in the final 2 minutes, first quarter, lead 20-14. DeAnthony Bowden, run inside, fouled by J.J. Sullinger. Good, get him in foul difficulty. But again, what did I tell you? We have had Fountain guarding DeAnthony Bowden. We've had Harvey Thomas guarding DeAnthony Bowden. And now J.J. Sullinger was guarding DeAnthony Bowden. They switch a lot. And Sullinger's already got a couple of fouls. Get him into foul difficulty. DeAnthony Bowden from the line has been wonderful. Got it. DeAnthony Bowden. 3 of 3 from the line tonight. He was 7 of 7 from the line last night. In his great Thursday night game, he was 14 of 16 from the line. DeAnthony Bowden now has 7 points. Looking for point number 8. The bend of the knee is the arch of the ball. The ripple. Oh, he missed it. I jinxed him. 21-14. We've scored 5 straight points. Cavs have scored 5 unanswered. High left, they've got Neely. Low left, looking for Freeman. Backing on Ellis. We're going to double to Fountain. The Cav defense has been wonderful. Harvey Thomas only 6 to shoot. To Neely, low left. We triple Fountain. Find Sullinger, high right, off-balance shot, miss it. They get a Neely putback. The Cavs did such a great defensive job. The Cavs did such a great defensive job on Albany. Then they forced Sullinger into a horrible shot, but they got the Neely offensive rebound and putback. Elvin Mims, right wing, step-back jumper, does not go. Tip, no. Another tip, loose, still loose. Sean, pick it up. Sean Daniels has the ball. Give it to Ellis, run the lane, put it up. Miss it. Sean trying to tip the rebound. Fountain has it. They've got numbers on a fast break. 3-on-2, Fountain finger roll. Got it, and he was fouled. Sean Fountain, first deuce of the night. Sean Fountain, first deuce of the night, fouled by Brandon Dean. Boy, that's a big swing. We missed the shot at one end, and they get a good run out at the other end. Sean Fountain had 21 points, 5 rebounds, 8 assists last night as the Cavs lost in overtime, 111-109. Fountain trying to complete the 3-point play. He does just that. Wow. Albany has scored 5 straight. We scored 5 straight to get up 21-14. They've scored 5 straight. It's 21-19. Sean, high right, screen roll, pick and roll move to DeAnthony Bowden. Bad pass by Sean. DeAnthony Bowden and Sean did not communicate well there. Sean threw it to DeBow, trying to break to the baseline left area, and it went out of bounds. Neely coming up the right sideline for Albany. They're only down by 2. Neely run the lane. Left-handed hooker goes. Rod Neely has 4. We're all tied up. We're all tied up. They've scored 7 straight. We're all tied up at 21. This is the championship game of the CBA for 2009. Sean Daniels backing in the lane. They come to double. Shoot anyway. Got it. Sean Daniels. They came to double low on the left low block, and he got a no-look reverse layup. Harvey Thomas, head fake, run the lane, dump it off baseline right for Campbell. Back to Sean Fountain. Man, we're playing great defense. Look at their shot clock. They never started the shot clock for them. It still says 23. Two shots didn't go down. We've got an outlet to Sean after a missed shot. And the quarter ends before he can put it down. Cavs, as we go to the second quarter, have the 23-21 advantage. We're heading for quarter number two. Lawton-Fort Sill has the two-point lead at 23-21. And we're back in 60 seconds. The Cavs come your way on Magic 95. I just need one.
Ten seconds.
Thank you. Hi, everybody. Chris Needham back with you live. The Washington Avenue Armory in Albany, New York, where I have established permanent residence, bought a house, started a family. I've got three kids, sending them to college. I think I've been up here. Wow, we got up here last Sunday. So we've been here a while, but really, it has been fun. I like Albany, and not a bad town. I did see the sunshine once, and you think I am joking, Lawton, Oklahoma. I am not. I have been here since last Sunday. We had one day where the sun shined, and that's it. When I was up here last year over Christmas for about 4 days, the sun never came out. It just always seems to be overcast. All right, the Cavs are up 23-21. Cavs have, this is a factor. The Cavs have one assist and four turnovers. They've got three assists, four turnovers. Lawton-Fort Sill winning the rebounding battle, 14-11. We have three offensive rebounds. Elvin Mims already with five rebounds. He leads everybody. We're winning the rebounding battle, as we said, 14-11. The Cavs 9 of 20 from the floor. They're 9 of 23. Cavs 4 of 5 from the line. They are just 1 of 1 from the line. We are underway in the second quarter. Eddie Smith has come in for the Cavs. Courtney Williams and Daryl Crow have come in for the Cavs. Cavs lose it out of bounds on the right sideline. Well, that's interesting. Let's see. Elvin Mims is gone. We're giving him a rest. So Daryl Crow did not play at all. Daryl Crow did not play at all last night. And I don't think Daryl Crow has played at all in this series. And Courtney Williams has come in for Sean. We got to get somebody back quickly. Daryl Crow comes back quickly into the backcourt to get the basketball. We got to get it into the forecourt very quickly. Hurry, guys. Looping pass from Eddie Smith to Courtney Williams. Albany was trying a full court press there. Eddie Smith, good first step. Run, lay it up, Eddie. Got it. Eddie Smith. That's Folgers right there. Folgers, I've been joking about calling Eddie Smith Folgers. Instant coffee. We call him instant offense off the bench. Folgers just made a great sort of a head fake, like he was going to go outside, and he went to the bucket. Campbell at the other end, shoot for them. Tip in. Campbell missed the shot, but Harvey Thomas got a great tip in. And it's 25-23. Cavs' largest lead had been 7 early at 13-6. Eddie Smith again, high right. Again, penetrate between the double. Eddie, shoot. He was fouled. He'll have free throws. Folgers is doing the job. Eddie and the guys were laughing when I started saying I was using that nickname. But Eddie, the reason I started was 5 games ago, Eddie came off the bench and went bing, bam, boom, pop, zip, hit 6 of 7 from outside. and had 12 points off the bench in about a three-minute spell, and so I started calling him instant offense off the bench, just like instant coffee, Folgers. So Eddie Smith, boy, he's living up to Folgers tonight off the bench. Just started for the Cavs here in the second quarter. We played 59 seconds. Eddie already has 3 points. Another free throw. Got it. He's got 4 points. He's a 73% shooter from the line. He was 5 of 5 from the line last night. Cavs are up 27-23. Sean Fountain fouled by Eddie Smith. That is exactly what Michael was talking about on the pregame show then. Slow these guys down. Last night at halftime, the score was 60-50. That is too wide open for Michael Ray. Doesn't like that type of game. Albany with the ball. This is a Harvey Thomas run. Right side, bank it up. Miss it. Rebound comes off to Ellis. We've got numbers. Get it to Eddie. DeAnthony Bowden will give it back to Ellis. Fouled as he goes to the glass, and that's the key again. Get them in foul difficulty. They've called the foul on Mike Campbell. Ellis will have free throws. Cavs are up 27-23. They're having to clear their bench, too. Lucius Jordan, a guy who killed us last night. Lucius Jordan, they interviewed him in the paper. He went to the University of Albany right down the road here. Ellis, free throw for the Cavs. Got it. Tim Ellis, first point. We are 3, 4, 5, 6. We've got 7 points from the line already. This is a big factor. And 8 points from the line. Ellis made them both. And the Cav advantage goes up to 29-23. But Lucius Jordan hardly played this year. He only averaged 4 points a game. Last night, he killed us with 17 points, 3 of 3 from three-point range. Cavs have the 29-23 advantage. Campbell work on Courtney Williams. He's in the paint. Shot blocked. Darryl Crow blocked the shot. Darryl Crow with a great shot block. Cavs go the other way. DeAnthony Bowden get it. Eddie at the head of the lane. Eddie Smith. Cavs have the ball in a six-point lead. We isolate the left side for Eddie. Backing, 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 spinning, shooting, missing. He was hammered. No whistle. That's been happening a lot here. Fountain run. Lay it off. Freeman dropped the ball. Albany trying to fast break. We're not letting them move that well. Good defense, guys. We played 2 minutes, second quarter. Cavs are up 29-23. Back cut, though. Back cut, though. Courtney Williams. Courtney Williams let Harvey Thomas cut behind him. Alley-oop feed and the jam. Sean Fountain with the alley and Harvey Thomas with the oop. At the other end, Darryl Crow traveled. Uh-oh. Well, we had momentum. We had momentum, and then the Cavs have made two mistakes. Courtney Williams let Thomas get behind him on a back cut for the alley-oop. Harvey Thomas has 8. It's 29-25, and then we had a travel at the other end. 9:40 left until halftime. The good news is Albany only has 25 points. We're playing very good defense. Sean Fountain run the lane. Give it to Harvey Thomas, right baseline jumper. Doesn't go. We get the Eddie Smith rebound. Slow it up now. Control tempo. Albert White's ready to come in for the Cavs. We're playing everybody so far except Aaron Smith. Eddie Smith, high left. Get to the head of the lane between the circles now. Eddie Smith, 10 to shoot, Eddie. Penetrates. Nice run. Lay it up. Hammered again. Hammered again. No whistle. Ball loose, and Courtney Williams gets the basketball and drops it out of bounds. But a lot of contact again inside, no whistle. I'm looking at John Zelpst, our owner, across the way. Michael Ray and Mike Brown. John Zelpst, our owner, and Mike Brown, our two owners are sitting side by side. John Zelpst's mouth just dropped 6 feet, and just how can you not call something? And Michael Ray Richardson is trying to bite his tongue, but it is ludicrous how our guys are going inside and getting hammered, and no whistle. Campbell for them at the other end. Trying to get it inside, and now they call a ticky-tacky hand-check foul on Darryl Crow. Folks, this is a joke early, I got to tell you. Michael Ray is not believing this. And John, I'm looking at our owner, John Zelpst, across the way. He is beside himself. We had Eddie Smith, timeout on the floor. The Cavs are up 29-25, and I've stayed away from jumping the officials, but I'm keeping my broadcast right here during this timeout. On that last trip, Eddie Smith drove down the right of the lane and ended up on the floor at the base of the basket support. No whistle. The ball came loose. Courtney Williams had it. Two men collapsed on him, pushed him, shoved him, fouled him. Ball went out of bounds. They said out of bounds off of Courtney Williams. We come down the floor, and Darryl Crow below the free throw line, which is legal. You can't hand check above the free throw line, but below the free throw line, he was trying to set up on Harvey Thomas. They called a ticky-tacky hand check foul. This right now is a joke as far as the officiating is concerned. I say that, and yet they have one free throw, And the Cavs have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We've got 9 free throws. So I've got to temper that and give them the benefit of the doubt there. So I apologize. But it's just, you know, that last trip was something else. Hey, Magic 95. We're very proud of this. Magic 95, the OAB, the Oklahoma Association of Broadcaster Awards, came out last week. Magic 95 is the winner of the 2008 OAB Non-Metro Radio Play-by-Play Broadcast. Our play-by-play broadcasts on Magic 95 have won the State of Oklahoma Award for Non-Metro Areas, and Magic 95 also won the 2008 Non-Metro Radio General Image Promotion for our Easter Egg Hunt promotion. Last year, probably right around Easter time, right? No other Lawton station won any awards, so we're proud of that for Magic 95. Cavs are up 29-25. We're back to play. 5 to shoot for Albany. I don't know if they know it. Campbell, 2 to shoot, 1 to shoot, step back jumper, air ball. They get the weak side rebound. And Fountain will run, kick it right back to Campbell, high right wing. We're playing tight defense. Courtney Williams is on Campbell. He runs, lays it up. Courtney is not doing a very good defensive job. Mike Campbell got an easy layup. It is 29-27, and here comes Elvin Mims. I called that. Courtney's going to come out. He is not doing a good defensive job. DeAnthony Bowden, high left wing, 13 to shoot, now 10 to shoot. Albert White will shoot from high left, miss it. Darryl Crow trying to follow. Can't do it. They get the rebound for Fountain. Campbell runs, lays it up, and is fouled by Darryl Crow. We'll get Elvin Mims in for Courtney Williams here very quickly. Courtney looks a little overmatched out there. Blocking foul, 8:04 left. 8:04 left until halftime. Lawton-Fort Sill, your Cavs have a 29-27 advantage. Campbell was fouled. He'll go to the line. Now, understand, we're talking about some of the officials missing calls, and, you know, I don't want to jump the gun, but we have 9 trips to the line, and this is only their second trip to the line. Campbell, shoot, got it. Mike Campbell has 3 points. He is an 89% shooter from the line, so Elvin Mims does come in for Courtney, and as soon as Elvin Mims got off the bench, I knew he was going in for Courtney Williams because Courtney has not really been doing a good defensive job in the low block. Campbell made both free throws. We're all tied up. Cavs' largest lead early had been 13-6. That was a 7-point lead. This is DeAnthony Bowden trying to get Elvin Mims to set a pick for him. Give it to Eddie. Eddie to Darryl Crow. Baseline left corner to DeAnthony Bowden. High. They're playing a zone. Bowden inside. Kick it to Albert White. Forward to shoot. Pop a jumper. Got it! Albert White! Cavs are back up 31-29. They run quickly. Campbell goes into the lane and contact on Albert White. They've called the foul on Albert White. He was trying to draw the charge, but they say he was not set up stationary. 7:35 left in your second quarter. Lawton-Fort Sill with the 2-point advantage. Sean Fountain, high right wing, guarded by Eddie Smith. Get it low, right block for Campbell. Backing, cross-court pass. Wide open, Lucius Jordan, 3. Miss it. Weak side rebound, Elvin Mims. Elvin Mims now with 6 rebounds already. 7:20 left. We're getting good rest for our guards so far. This is Eddie to Albert White to DeAnthony Bowden running the lane. Shot blocked. That was a pretty good block by Freeman. They're running. Lucius Jordan coast to coast. Shot blocked. Shot blocked, and they called a hand check foul on Darryl Crow. Come on. Now, I said we're getting, yeah, this is by design. Very good. Eddie Smith was giving Brandon Dean some rest on the guard line. Now Brandon Dean comes in to give DeAnthony Bowden some rest. So we're rotating guards very well. Good move by Michael Ray. He knows this game will be won on the guard line late in the contest. Jordan was fouled. Shoot a free throw. Got it. Lucius Jordan, out of the University of Albany, right down the road, gets his first point. He had 17 points, 3 of 3 from three-point range last night. Lucius Jordan, second free throw, is up. It is down. That ties the game at 31. We're all knotted up in the CBA title game. This is it. The season is over. It's all over after tonight. Whoever wins this will have a little party tonight, I guarantee you. We're spreading the offense, working against their zone. They're getting it low right to Elvin Mims, to Albert White. A high right 3 doesn't go. They get a good box out for Campbell. gets the defensive rebound away from Daryl Crow. Campbell will run, bank it up right side, miss it. That's a nice rebound for Albert White. Outlet Elvin Mims. We've got numbers. Decides not to shoot quickly. Eddie, good feed inside to Crow. Turnaround jumper, Daryl Crow. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Daryl Crow. Cavs are up 33-31. Nice assist, Eddie Smith to Crow. Jordan at the other end. Run, shoot, miss. Nice rebound, Elvin Mims. His seventh rebound. Jump ball, you got to be kidding. I thought Elvin got credit for that. He will not. 6:21 left, second quarter. Lawton-Fort Sill has the two-point advantage at 33-31. Jump ball, Elvin Mims and Lucius Jordan, who tied him up. Ball is in the air. Cavs control. Nice back tip from Elvin Mims to Brandon Dean to Eddie coming up the right sideline. Cavs with the ball in the two-point lead. 6:15 left until halftime. Brandon Dean right back to Eddie. High right. Low right corner, Daryl Crow. Long jumper. Doggone it. Will not go. Daryl Crow missed a three. Harvey Thomas has the rebound. Loop it. Low right. Turnaround jumper in the sky. Toby Smith. Miss it. Elvin Mims with his eighth rebound. Elvin Mims is doing a great job on the glass. Elvin Mims last night had 14 points, 9 rebounds, already has 8, 5:50 left. This is Brandon Dean, high left wing. 10 to shoot, find Eddie Smith. Eddie lost the basketball. He tried to go down the right of the lane. They're running. Lucius Jordan lost the basketball. Tip for tap. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Eddie lost it, then Lucius Jordan lost it. Timeout, 5:41 left. This is Cavalry basketball. This is the type of game. As I told you last night, the Cavs at halftime led 60-50. I mean, that was great. Michael does not want to score 60 points. The Cavs led at halftime last night 60-50, but he did not want the game to be that wide open. He wants to play this type of half-court, low-scoring, ring-it-up, work-inside-type basketball. Cavs are up 33-31. Cavs by two. Timeout on the floor. 5:41 left until halftime. A 60-second break. You're listening to Lawton-Fort Sill Cavalry Basketball on Magic 95.
Seconds, Chris.
You're great. Thank you. It's 12. It's 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22, 31, 33. Lawton-Fort Sill, your Cavs come back on the floor with Elvin Mims, Eddie Smith, Daryl Crow getting some more playing time. Daryl, last time he played superbly, but he hasn't played in this final series yet. Albert White and Brandon Dean. So that is three subs, three players from the bench and two starters. Eddie Smith, head of the lane, high left side, find Brandon Dean. Looping pass inside to Mims, give it to Albert White, baseline left corner, run, reverse layup, doesn't get the go. Oh, and he got a tip! Albert White didn't get it to go, and Eddie got a tip! Folgers got a tip! I think that's his first offensive tip of the year. The Cavs are up 35-31. That'll be like a pitcher talking about hitting a home run in baseball. Eddie will brag about that. I got an offensive putback. Elvin Mims just fouled Campbell at the other end. You know, in baseball, how a pitcher pitches 7-8 wonderful innings, but gets a base hit or a home run, and the pitchers want to talk about that. Eddie Smith just got an offensive tip. And, I mean, he's had some offensive crashing to the boards and slams and putbacks, but that time he was sort of off balance and tipped it up, and it went down. Campbell was fouled. He's got a couple of free throws. Mike Campbell makes the first. He's 3 of 3 from the line, and the officials doing their best to even up the free throw shooting now. The Cavs had a 9-1 advantage in free throws early. Campbell has now made 4 of 4. His deuce from the line right there makes it 35-33. 5 minutes exactly left until halftime. 5 minutes remaining until halftime. We're getting Sean Daniels a lot of rest. He hadn't played at all in the second quarter. That's good. Eddie Smith to Albert White. Good feed inside to Elvin Mims on the baseline. Head fake. Up and under move. Got it! Got it! He got it! Elvin Mims with a bucket. It went down. They knocked it out of the cylinder, but we get credit for it. The Cavs are up 37-33. Elvin Mims is playing a game and a half. He's got 4 points, but 9 rebounds, I believe. Could be 8. This is a Sean Fountain running off a pick. High left. Return it to Campbell. Elvin Mims, nice defensive job on him. Albert White with the switch off now. Albert White, nice switch. Run. Off-balance shot doesn't go. Albert White fouls at Campbell. We're not playing help defense right now. We're playing strict man-to-man. But that's all right. We'll play help defense late. Help defense really involves a lot of jumping and anticipation. It's harder. It's a lot of times like in college basketball when you play zone mainly, and then when you have to go to a man-to-man, it takes more effort. You're almost always playing man-to-man in the pros, and then sometimes you got to go to the weak side help-type defense, which involves even more switching and matchups and running and everything. Boy, Campbell was fouled again. He goes to the line again. It is obvious Derek Rowland has made an offensive switch, and they are trying to get their guys to the free-throw line. At one point in the game, we had 9 free throws. They had only 1. Campbell makes both free throws. Right now, Albany, that's 6, 7, 8. They've got 9 free throws as well. Cavs have the ball in the 2-point lead. Brandon Dean, high left wing, wanting a pick from Albert White. Screen roll play, but Eddie gets it high right back to Brandon Dean. Give it to Albert White, baseline left jumper. Got it! That's a 3! A triple for the big guy! Albert White with the triple. And the Cavs are up 40-35. Albany runs. Campbell again going inside. Drop the ball! We've got the ball, and the Cavs are going to bring it up slowly. Here comes Eddie Smith. Eddie Smith back to Albert White, to Elvin Mims, to Brandon Dean. Wonderful ball movement. Free throw line extended right wing, head of the lane. They call a illegal defense against the Albany Patroons. That'll slow things down a little bit, which again is what the Cavs want. Eddie Smith. Eddie Smith will get the technical free throw. That is a 3-second defensive violation. Cavs up by 5. We had a 7-point lead early at 13-6. Cavs have a 6-point lead as Folgers makes a free throw. He's 3 of 3 from the line. Bowden is 3 of 4 from the line. Ellis is 2 of 2 from the line. Sean Daniels made a free throw. Cavs are up 41-35. Back up by 6. If we convert on this trip, it'll be our biggest lead of the night. Elvin Mims up. Back high left to Eddie. Run the lane, Eddie. Finger roll. Doesn't go. Tip up doesn't go. Keep it alive, Cavs. No. Boy, Eddie should have banked that one up. Doggone it, I'm sure he'll feel bad about that. Albany going the other way from left to right. They've got Freeman, Deshaun Fountain. They're going to get J.J. Sullinger back in, a whistle away from the activity. They've called another ticky-tacky foul on Darold Crow. And Michael Ray Richardson is beside himself. Darold Crow has picked up 2 ticky-tacky fouls. I mean, tic-tac city. I ain't talking breath mint here. Tic-tac city right there. Little hand check fouls on Darold Crow. On Harvey Thomas. Harvey Thomas will go to the line. So again, they're going to the line. The free throw discrepancy has been changed around. Harvey Thomas now 9 points. He makes that free throw. Harvey Thomas not a great free throw shooter. 65% from the line. That makes it 41-36. 41-37. He made them both. 3.5 left, second quarter. 3:30 left in your second quarter. The Cavs are up 41-37. Eddie Smith plays a two-man game on the left of the block for Albert White. Backing, they come to double. Nice feed inside to Darold Crow. Albert White, a wonderful feed to Darold Crow, who tomahawks it down. And Sean Fountain called for an offensive foul as Eddie Smith comes over and does a good defensive job on their out-of-bounds play. Nice job, Eddie Smith. Cavs are up 43-37. Cavs by 6. Cavs have a side out, left sideline. Eddie playing great. Folgers. Eddie Smith. Again, the two-man game with Albert White. Low left side. Wheel to the glass. Albert, they're not coming to double. And they call the foul. I thought they were going to call that on Albert White. They call the foul on Sullinger. He's got 3 already, I think. I'm going to take back what I said about the officiating. They're trying to. They're trying. That's why I... Earlier this year, I was learning all the, and I was using the officials' names. I don't do that anymore. I don't want to make officiating such a major part of the game. We've just got to play your game. That was a good call, really. So a couple of free throws for Albert White. First is up and down. Boy, the Cavs are doing a good job. You know, on the season, the Cavs are just a 67% free throw shooting team. They were at 76%. Albert White with six. Albert White with seven. And the Cavs have the largest lead of the evening. This is our largest lead, 45-37. And the Cavs are going to get the ball back. We made good defensive pressure on the out-of-bounds play. Derek Rowland calls a timeout. Cavs are going to get the ball back. We could go up to a 10-point lead. I was looking down at my score sheet. I think what it was is they tried to hand it off. I was looking down at my score sheet, and all of a sudden they said it was Cav ball. You can't hand off from out-of-bounds to inbounds. You can't hand off. Michael had jumped up. I looked down there, and I couldn't see exactly what happened. I'm going to keep my broadcast here during a timeout. Hey, you great folks at Brady's. Hello, everybody at Brady's. You know, we're on the internet with their webcast as well. And I look over there, and our Cavalry fans who have come up with John Zelps and Mike Brown, they turn around and look at the cameras, and they're waving. Are you seeing them there? They're having a good time. All right, that was another turnover. That's back-to-back turnovers against Albany. Timeout on the floor. The Cavs are up by 8 at 45-37. Our largest lead early was 13-6. We were in a 4-4 tie. We went up 10-6, then, 10-4, then 13-6. Then they came back, and it was close for quite a while. I'll go through the entire running play-by-play for you at halftime, and we'll go through all the statistics as well. But Cavs have led the majority of the contest. Let me see now. Have we led all the way? It was tied at 4, then 10-4, 13-6, 16-12, 16-14. We were up. They tied it at 21. Cavs went ahead 23-21, 25-23, 29. I'm going through my running play-by-play. Tied at 31, 35. They've never led. Albany has never led this basketball game. There have been several ties, but they've never led. We could lead by 10 if we convert here. Bring it in to Eddie, high right wing. Cross court to Brandon, take a three. Does not go. They get the rebound. Boy, that would have been a dagger right there. That would have been a dagger. Cavs have the 8-point lead. Albany has the basketball. 2:55 left. Second quarter. Fountain, fake right, go left. Bounce it, right side, looking for Neely. Neely isolated on Albert White. Backing. He's going to kick it to Harvey Thomas. Sean Fountain has it high right side. Five to shoot for Neely. And then he travels. Oh, the Cavalry defense has been amazing. The Cavs are winning this basketball game with defense, folks. Albany, we are just 2:40 away. We are just 2:40 away from halftime, and Albany has only 37 points. The Cavs are playing great defense. This is Elvin Mims to Brandon Dean. Cross court to Albert White. Wide open right wing jumper. Three. Boom, boom, boom. Albert White has 10 points, and the Cavs are up by 11. At the other end, Harvey Thomas shoots, score, and he was fouled by Albert White. Wow, they went to their bread and butter right there. Harvey Thomas is their leading scorer. He's got 12. It goes down. He's got a free throw coming, but our advantage had gone up to the largest lead of the evening, obviously. Harvey Thomas completes the three-point play with the free throw. And it's 48-40. Cavs had been up by 11. Here is Albert White. White, baseline right corner, giving it to Brandon Dean. 2 minutes left, second quarter to Eddie Smith. High left, back to Brandon. Brandon at the between the circles to Albert White. Spinning, four to shoot, drop step, jumper. Miss it, tip in Cavs for Daryl Crow. Does not go. Out of bounds, last touch by Daryl Crow. But Daryl Crow should be proud of himself. Second-year pro out of Tulsa is playing very well. Lawton-Fort Sill with the 48-40 advantage. A minute 50 left until halftime. Freeman up the left sideline. Fountain to Harvey Thomas, high right. Now at the head of the lane on the right side. Harvey Thomas, we are playing the best defense the Cavs have played all year long. Harvey Thomas, guarded by Albert White, has to take a long three, and he got it. Holy smoke! He's got 16 points. 48-43, a minute 25 left. Boy, what a dagger that was for Harvey Thomas. Brandon Dean, high left, get a pick from Albert White. Wanted the screen roll play, but Eddie gets a return pass to Daryl Crow. Free throw line extended right wing. Head of the lane for Eddie. Eddie, penetrate. Eddie, spin. Eddie was fouled by Lucius Jordan. Cavalry, out of bounds play, side out. We're not in the penalty as of yet. We're not in the bonus yet. Minute 14 remaining until halftime. Lawton-Fort Sill, 48-43. We did have a 48-37 advantage. We were up by 11. Largest lead. This is Eddie, high left. Give it to Elvin Mims, head of the lane. Right back to Eddie, six to shoot, minute to play. Eddie, spin, run down the lane. Nice dump off to Albert White for an easy layup. Easy layup. That was a great assist for Eddie. Cavs up 50-43. Harvey Thomas, bank shot, left side, does not go. They call another foul on Daryl Crow. I had to listen to those words ringing through my head. Harvey Thomas does not go. He was fouled by Daryl Crow. I'm sorry, but that had iambic pentameter or something. Harvey Thomas, free throw, missed one finally. Golly, he's been red hot. So the Cavs' advantage is still 7, Lawton-Fort Sill, 50-43. We're going to lead at halftime again, but this is a little more sanity as far as the pace of the ball game. Harvey Thomas has 17, made the next free throw, 50-44. Control the clock now a little bit, guys. This is Eddie Smith, high left wing. Boy, we've given a lot of our guys a lot of rest. That's good. Eddie Smith, try to penetrate. Kick it to Albert, another three. Missed this one, and the rebound will go out of bounds. The three hit the back heel, went out of bounds on the left sideline. 37 seconds left for Albany. Cavs are up 50-44. We got to keep playing good defense. Eddie Smith dogging Sean Fountain. Eddie's done a great job on him. Fountain backing. Kick it high right wing, finding Neely. Run inside, dump it off for a Jordan three. Won't go. Rebound tipped for Albert White in the outlet. He throws it away. He threw it right to Lucius Jordan, and an easy bucket for Neely. That's a killer. That's a killer. That's a killer. Oh, my. Boy, the Cavs could have had a much bigger lead at halftime. We're going to take the final shot. 9 seconds left. 8 seconds left. 7 seconds left. Cavs up 50-46. Brandon, take a three. Boom! Oh, ho, ho! Brandon Dean just hit a triple. Cavs are up 53-46. Harvey Thomas at the buzzer. A jumper doesn't go. The Cavs will take a 53-46 lead into the locker room. The Cavs will take a 7-point lead into the locker room. You are saying as you listen. Wow, that's wonderful. Well, we led by 10 last night. The Cavs last night at halftime led 60-50. And then it developed into a tight ball game in the second half, and we ended up losing in overtime. But that's the first half, and the key to this one, the absolute key to this one was defense. My goodness, did Lawton-Fort Sill play great defense. Thank you. They just gave me statistics. I'll take my two-minute break in just a little bit. But first, let me just give you numbers. This is what I thought. Albany from the floor. Folks, Albany was the highest-scoring team in the league at 107 points a game. Albany from the floor in the first half was 9 of 23. Oh, Cavs, what a job. Now, we weren't that much better, but that's, Michael doesn't care. We were 9 of 20, but that's 45%. Albany was at 39%. The major key was Albany just 9 of 23 from the floor, and we gave them a bucket right there at the end. Could have been 8 of 22, even better. That's the key. The Cavs played wonderful defense. So at halftime, we are 24 minutes of basketball away from a CBA championship for one of these two teams, and I'll tell you, Michael Ray wants this desperately. All of the Cavs want this thing desperately. We're on the halftime show. We take a break at halftime. Your halftime show always sponsored by the Comanche Home Center. Let the Comanche Home Center be the MVP of your next building project. They've got services like free accurate estimates for remodeling projects and new home construction. Comanche Home Center, a proud sponsor of your Lawton-Fort Sill Cavalry. Your halftime breaks always sponsored by the Comanche Home Center, always at halftime when we don't have an interview. Last night we interviewed both John Zelps and Mike Brown about the commissioner's meeting, the owner's meetings up here. And I guarantee you folks, Lawton, I'm telling you something right now. I mean, I know for a fact there will be professional basketball in Lawton next season.
And we didn't start till after the first of the year this year, but next probably late November, December, there will be, mark it down, there will be pro basketball in Lawton next year. What's going to happen? A different type of CBA? Rumors about different leagues? I don't know. Nobody knows. But this group is so committed to the support that you have given us, and it's going to happen, and it'd be great. It'd be great to top off this year with another championship.
That's impressive, but I don't think it's going to happen.
Phil Kennedy just let me know over there at Brady's that, yeah, you have been looking at John Zelps and Mike Brown and our fans here screaming and hollering, so we thank you, and you're enjoying the broadcast. There are those of you elsewhere who are punched into the webcast and listening to our Magic 95 simulcast on the web as well, so you've got video and audio, so we thank you for that. And hey, more than 50 of you over there at Brady's, how you doing? Glad you're with us. And all of you listening on Magic 95, that's what I'm talking about, the great support that we've had all year long in Lawton. That is something I am so proud to be a part of, and I'm so proud that it has happened, and there will be professional basketball in Lawton next year. Again, in case you didn't hear our announcement earlier, Magic 95 won the OAB Awards came out. Every year, the Oklahoma Association of Broadcasters have awards, and the 2008 awards came out. Magic 95 won the 2008 Non-Metro Radio General Image Promotion for the Easter Egg Hunt. I remember promoting that on our Cavalry broadcast last year. No other Lawton radio station won any awards. We also won at Magic 95 the 2008 OAB Non-Metro Radio Award for play-by-play for these Cavalry broadcasts. So we're proud of that. Thank you for your support. We're back in 2 minutes. And I'll give you all the running play-by-play, how we got to this point. The Cavs are up by 7. Our largest lead had been 11 at 48-37. How did it go? I'll let you know, then give you all the statistics when we return in 2 minutes on our Comanche Home Center halftime show. Cavs, come your way on Magic 95.
Fat people.
Where are the stat people? Can you ask him for a halftime box if they've got stats there?
Halftime box.
They got stats?
Where's the box? I don't...
Chris, 10 seconds.
Okie doke. Chris Needham back with you live on Magic 95. We're at halftime of the CBA title game. It is all over in 24 minutes of basketball. One of these teams will win the championship, and the Cavs have been playing superb defense. Well, but that's not the halftime box.
I thought
I gave you one. I didn't give you one. I put it right
there. That's what you gave me.
Oh, did I?
Yeah, but that's not the halftime box.
Yeah, okay.
See? That's 23-21. They need to print out the halftime box, if you will. Thank you. I'm trying to get statistics here. I'm sorry for talking live like that, but there's only one man here. And they gave us a box, and they said that was your halftime statistics, but they only had five Cavalry players listed, and we've had nine Cavs play. There it is. Thank you. Thank you. They gave me the wrong sheet. Okay. 53-46. We'll do that after we take another two-minute break. I apologize for that. They gave me a box that was, they only had five Cavalry players listed. We played nine players, everybody but Aaron Smith, and everybody has played well. All right, we'll give you all the statistics after we go through the running play-by-play. We're on the Comanche Home Center. Halftime show for your next building project. Make Comanche Home Center a part of your team with quality materials and on-time delivery. You'll never be on the bench. Comanche Home Center, a proud sponsor of your Lawton-Fort Sill Cavs. Albany has never led in this basketball game. That's why at halftime I always like to go through the running play-by-play and find out some of the ebbs and flows of the game, that while I'm doing the play-by-play, sometimes it's hard to realize it, but we got the first bucket for DeAnthony Bowden. Albany tied it. Harvey Thomas, 2-2. Bowden scored again, 4-2. Then Harvey Thomas scored again to make it 4-4. DeAnthony Bowden scored to make it 6-4. And from that point, we have never lost the lead. We got up 10-4. Then the Cavs got up 13-6. An early 7-point lead had been the biggest. Cavs led 16-12, 16-14. We got up 21-14. Which was another 7-point lead, but then Albany got seven straight points to tie the game at 21. So we've had several ties, but at the end of the first quarter, the Cavs led 23-21. We led 25-23, 29-23. They came back to within 29-27 and tied it again at 29. Cavs went up 31-29. They tied it again at 31. Cavs went up 35-33. And they've never come back to tie since then. We pushed it up to 37-33. Cavs led 37-35, ran off four straight to go up 41-35. And then that came our best offensive surge, really keyed by great defense. We pushed it up to 45-37. Then Albert White hit a three to make it 48-37, our largest lead of 11. Albany came back with six straight points to make it 48-43. Cavs pushed it to 50-43, and at halftime now lead 53-46. So I'm glad we went through that running play-by-play. It's interesting to note how many ties there were. Albany came from behind a tie, but Albany has never led this basketball game. And the Cavs doing a phenomenal job defensively. That's the whole key. What are the statistics defensively? Well, we'll give them to you in 2 minutes. Let's go ahead and take one more two-minute break on our halftime show, and then I'll come back and go through all the statistics for you and get ready for the final two quarters of 2009 CBA basketball with your Cavs. Do we have another championship ring on the horizon? We're going to find out pretty quickly. Back in 2 minutes, Cavs come your way on Magic 95.
I'm
Chris, coming up in 10.
Thank you. That's why I love at halftime pouring over the stat sheets for you guys, because that's where you find out what's going on and just some amazing things. This is a great number right here. DeAnthony Bowden's played 17 minutes. Brandon Dean's played 19 minutes. Mims has played 20 minutes. Tim Ellis has played 15 minutes. Sean and Eddie Smith have played 12 minutes. All right, you got all those numbers? Albert White has played just over 8 minutes. Albert White has just played over 8 minutes. Albert leads all Cavs scorers with 12 points. You talk about a guy coming off the bench and doing the job. Albert White has hit two threes. He's 4 of 9 from the floor, 2 of 2 from the line. He's got a couple of rebounds, 12 points. Albert White leading all Cavs scorers with 12 points, but we've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Cavs who have scored. Courtney Williams has played but has not scored. Aaron Smith has not played. All right, team numbers first. Cavs are 19 of 41. Oh, at the beginning of the half, I gave you some false numbers. I'm sorry. That's what I was talking about. They gave me a bad score sheet. I just glanced at it when they handed it to me. That was partial. Now this is for real. Okay, it's even better. The Cavs are 19 of 41, 46%. We've held them to 15 of 39. The key is the Cavs have more shots than Albany, 41 to 39. So Albany is shooting just 39%. The Cavs at 46%. Rebounding, the Cavs are winning the rebounding battle big time, 24-20. We've got 5 offensive rebounds, so do they. That was a factor in the first two games. They were getting a lot more offensive rebounds, so that's a big factor. Assist-to-turnover ratio, not a factor in this game. The Cavs have 6 assists, 9 turnovers. They've got 5 assists, 8 turnovers. But the big statistic, we've held Albany to just 39 shots. They're 15 of 39, 39%. They are only 3 of 11 from three-point range, and a lot of times that's their bread and butter. We've had guys with a hand in their face, just great. All right, free throws about the same. The Cavs are 11 of 12 from the line. What a big factor. They're 13 of 14 from the line. So it has evened up pretty well. Foul trouble, Daryl Crow has 4 fouls for the Cavs. J.J. Sullinger for them has 3 fouls. The only guy in difficulty there. Harvey Thomas is their leading scorer with 17. Nobody else in double figures. Albert White, our leading scorer, with 12. Good balance. DeAnthony Bowden has 7. Brandon Dean has 8. Sean Daniels has 9. Eddie Smith has 7. Great balance. Sean's back on the floor. I tell you, Michael Ray is very happy, I am sure, that he got Sean Daniels an entire quarter of rest and DeAnthony Bowden as well. I mean, you know, we got a lot of rest for these guys. Elvin Mims got some rest, but Sean sat out the entire second quarter. And getting him rest and fresh legs, that's important. Sean Daniels was 4 of 7 from the floor in the first half. He had his 9 points, 2 rebounds. Elvin Mims, 4 points, but he had 8 rebounds. So we're underway. This is it. This is it. I'm almost sad here now. I've got a lump in my throat. This is it. I hate to say it. This is our last game of this year. We've got to get a championship, guys. Albany is playing right in front of my broadcast position now. Cavs, as we go to the third quarter, up 53 to 46. Neely working left wing jumper. No. Weak side rebound. That's Elvin Mims, his 9th. Elvin Mims got his 9th rebound already last night. He had 9 in the entire game. Brandon Dean to Elvin Mims. High left, now high right to DeAnthony Bowden. Saw a lane, tried to work it inside. Bad pass, stolen by Harvey Thomas. They've got a 2-on-2 break. Thomas run, lay it up, got it. Well, that was not very good. The Cavs had an offensive opportunity, turned it over. They scored. That's a big 4-point swing. Cavs 53 to 48. Debout, high left wing. Trying to look for a cutter. It is Sean coming high. Sean, go to the glass. Spin. Sean, lay it up. He got it. A flop by Harvey Thomas. He tried that last night. Harvey Thomas tried a Vlade Divac flop the way Vlade Divac used to do it for the Sacramento and the Lakers. He just flopped to try to get the call. Didn't get it. Harvey Thomas, good feet inside to a wide open. Gabe Freeman tried to lay it up and score. It was blocked away by DeAnthony Bowden, but they called the foul on Debo. That was a good move for Sean. He's got 11. The Cav advantage went up to 55-48. Cavs by 7. The foul that sends Freeman to the line for free throws. Boy, both teams are just hitting the free throws amazingly. Albany is now 14 of 15, 15 of 16 from the line. And it is 55-50. The Cavs are 11 of 12 from the line. This is a great free throw shooting exhibition. Cavs have the ball, 10 and a half to play, third quarter. Whistle away from the activity this time. Another illegal defense against Albany. I told you on my pregame show how DeAnthony Bowden was complaining after the game last night that those guys were chickens. They were playing a zone, and they do play a zone. A lot of teams will play variations of a zone. DeAnthony Bowden makes the free throw. On the technical, he has 8 points. Cavs have the 56-50 lead and the ball. Elvin Mims, baseline right corner, finding Brandon Dean with 7 to shoot. Back to Elvin to DeBow. Take a three! Does not go. DeAnthony Bowden in his great night 2 nights ago was 10 of 11 from three-point range. Harvey Thomas drives the length of the floor. Ball stolen. We've got an outlet. Bowden, run, lay it up. Got it! DeAnthony Bowden has 10 points. And the Cav advantage goes up to 8. Albany's trying to get a quick moving game. Reverse layup does not go for Sullinger. Rebound Cavs. Slow it down, guys. We were trying to run with them. Whenever Albany starts to run, you're tempted to run with them. And Michael says, slow it down. This is Sean halfway up the block left side looking for a cutter. Sean, he's not going to the glass as he was doing early. Give it to DeBow. Take another three. No, it's a great feed inside to Elvin Mims for an easy finger roll. It looked like DeAnthony Bowden was going to pop a triple. Instead, he said, Elvin, you take it. We're up by 10. Good guys' largest lead have been 11, 48-37. We're up 10 at 60-50. This is Sean Fountain, high left wing. Run off a pick. Get to the head of the lane on the right side. Ball tip free. Cavs make a steal. DeAnthony Bowden to Mims. He misses a jam. He was fouled. Elvin Mims misses a jam. Harvey Thomas fouled him. Great defense for the good guys, though. Great defense for the Cavs. This game is being won for Lawton-Fort Sill by amazing help defense. Elvin Mims, a couple of free throws on the agenda. He's an 89% shooter on the year. Great from the line, and the Cavs have been wonderful tonight. Elvin Mims, the free throw. Up, down. Elvin is money. Elvin is money. Let's see, from the line. The Cavs are now 12 of 13. I jinxed him. That's all my fault. Anytime I brag... We're up by 11 again. They go quickly the other way. Harvey Thomas, a three. Miss it. Rebound. Tim Ellis. Loose ball foul on Tim Ellis. They called a loose ball foul on Tim Ellis as he got that rebound of the missed Harvey Thomas three. Harvey Thomas was 6 of 10 from the floor last night with 19 points, 12 rebounds. Side out, left sideline. They get a new shot clock due to the Patroons. 9 minutes left, third quarter. Sean Fountain with the ball. Cavs with our largest lead of 11, 61-50. This is Sullinger spinning on Brandon Dean. Easy bank shot. Sullinger has 10 points. 61-52, Cavs by 9. We're under 9 minutes to play, third quarter. Sean, good feed to Mims in the paint. He retreats, gives it to DeBow, run the lane. They called a travel. DeAnthony Bowden is on the floor. Looked as if he were tripped, but they called a travel. And DeAnthony Bowden hits himself in the chest. My bad, my bad. He said, all right, I'm the one that turned it over. Alley-oop feed inside to Sullinger in the lane. He turns, he shoots, he got it. They've scored four straight. It was 61-50, now 61-54. Sullinger has 12 points. Elvin Mims high left in the lane. It'll come to Bowden. Dump it off to Sean. Right back to DeBow. Take another three. Can't get it to go. DeAnthony Bowden. It's amazing how he was so hot from three-point range the other night. And tonight he just can't get one to fall. He has not hit a three-pointer. I think he's 0 of 4. Bowden saw a lane, almost ran down it. We play a two-man game to the right of the block with Sean. Sean trying to back in. Sean go to the glass. Sean finger roll. Goaltending. Should have been. It looked as if he had it above the rim. It was knocked out of bounds by Harvey Thomas. We want the goaltending call. We won't get it. Cavs have the ball, though. Four to shoot. Come on, D-Bow. Four to shoot. Three to shoot. Find Sean. Take a three. Air ball. Brandon Dean telling Michael Ray Richardson, calm down. We've got this under control. Michael was unhappy because we had an 11-point lead. They've scored four straight. They've got the ball, and it looked like it was getting out of control a little bit. Brandon Dean says, Coach, we got this thing. Don't worry about it. Sean Fountain to Neely. High left for Albany. Low left to Freeman. Shoot. Fouled. Shot doesn't go. They'll call a cavalry foul on Elvin Mims, and the Cavs want a timeout. Is it a full? No, a 20. Just a 20-second short timeout for the Cavs. It always takes a lot more than 20 seconds, so I got time to brag about Adventure Travel. Hey, another great special for Adventure Travel as we go into spring. February 24th, an Oklahoma City departure. Three nights at the Luxor in Las Vegas, round-trip airfare, and those three nights at the Luxor, what a great hotel. I've stayed there. That's just $330 per person, double occupancy, an Acapulco trip from Adventure Travel, April 13th from DFW, four nights at the Fiesta Americana Villas, $630 per person with the flight, and your stay down there does not include meals and drinks, but that's a great deal. Adventure Travel at the Central Mall and the PX Mall. 800 number is 540-9030. Couple of shots coming for Gabe Freeman. The free throw shooting in this contest continues to be amazing. Freeman made the first. Here is the second. It's 61-55, 56. They have scored six straight points. Cavs' largest lead had been 11. We were proud of that 11-point lead, and all of a sudden they've cut it down to five with a run of six zip. The Anthony Bowden high right wing. Are we going to play the two-man game with Sean? Halfway up the block on the right side, we find Sean. We isolate. He'll run. Sean, lay it up. Got it. Sean Daniels took Harvey Thomas to school right there. Sean Daniels just ate Harvey Thomas up. Again, they are not starting the shot clock when Albany runs up the floor, and the officials have finally realized it. They give Albany about 4 or 5 seconds extra almost on every trip. They don't start the shot clock until they get across midcourt. We're playing on the road. This is Fountain outside the arc, high left. Work it to Harvey Thomas. Ball tipped free. We almost make a steal. Six to shoot. Five to shoot. Great defense, guys. Fountain working on DeAnthony Bowden. Cross court tipped away. They don't get the shot off in time. Great defense, Cavs. Hey, they had 27 seconds that time. The shot clock. They're always slow on the trigger, and they gave Albany 27 seconds that time, and we still held them without a shot. Amazing defense, guys. Way to go. Cavs up 63-56. 6:45 left, third quarter. Brandon Dean outside the arc, high on the left wing. Cavs lead it by seven. Give it to Sean. Albany has never led in this game. We isolate the entire right side for Sean. He's on the baseline right. Reverse it, high left. Brandon, take a three. Got it! Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. Cavs by 10, 66-56. That had to be 30 feet away. That was a 30-foot three for Brandon Dean. Albany down 10, 6 minutes left in the third quarter. Freeman high left working on Elvin Mims. Spin, shoot, score. Nice move. Nice move, Gabe Freeman. He has 8 points. That was worth the price of admission right there. That was a beautiful move. Cavs by eight were more than halfway through the third quarter. Good feed to Anthony Bowden to Sean. Sean Daniels trying to wheel back to the Anthony Bowden. Nine to shoot. Get a pick from Ellis. Give it Brandon Dean. Fake a three. Dribble closer. Find Ellis. Long jumper Tim Ellis. No. Rebound Harvey Thomas. Had a tip from Neely. Up the left sideline comes Fountain. He'll pop a three. Miss it. Rebound to Anthony Bowden, and the Cavs are on the run. Cavs on the run. And Bowden says slow it up. Then he runs. Kick it to Ellis. Now we'll slow it up again. This is the tempo that Michael Ray Richardson controls games with. 5:15 left, third quarter. Take the shot clock down. Brandon Dean, another three. Miss it. Rebound, Elvin Mims. Offensive putback. He got it. He got it. He got it. He's got nine, and the Cavs are up 10 again at 68. 69-58. play defense now. Under five to play. Sullinger go down the right of the lane. Scoop shot goes. That's a nice move for J.J. Sullinger. And he was fouled. Cavs lead at 69-60. 69-60, the Cav advantage with a timeout. 4:50, there it is. Okay, you heard my pause there. You heard my pause there because I looked at the scoreboard and I keep my own running play-by-play. And whoever runs the shot clock here, whoever runs the scoreboard here, well, they were giving it to us, so you can't complain, but they don't do a very good job. It was only 68-60, and I was pausing to see if they were going to change it, and they did. So, all right. Now we're right. Cavs are up 68-60. Timeout. We take a 60-second break. 4:52 left in the third quarter. Can the Cavs be 16 minutes and 52 seconds away from another CBA title? Stay tuned. Cavs come your way right here on Magic 95. I'm not live on the radio now, but I know there's a place where you can hear me, and Phil Kennedy says there are more than 50 of you there. That's a bunch. That's a bunch there. So is that called a Brady's bunch? I'm sorry. I'm glad I'm not on the radio.
Seconds, Chris.
Is this Al or Johnny? Yeah, they corrected the board because I knew the Cavs only had 68. They had put 69 up there, but what a big three that was for Brandon Dean. But before that stoppage of play, Sullinger had scored. He was fouled. That made it 68-60. Sullinger has 14. Trying to add a free throw to make it 15. They have only missed one free throw all night long. Sullinger makes that. I was hoping I could jinx him. 68-61. The key to this game has been cavalry defense. Play defense now, guys. All right. Cavs have the ball, obviously. D'Anthony Bowden up the left sideline. Head fake. Give it to Sean. Sean isolated on the left side. Run inside, Sean. Are they going to come to double? They don't. Give it to Mims. Pop a jumper. Got it. Alvin Mims hit a three. Alvin Mims, of all people, hit a triple. Alvin Mims pushes our advantage back up to 71-61. Sean just blocked the shot. We've got a three-on-one break. Bowden, give it to Brandon Dean. The layup goes down. He's got 13. The Cav advantage is 73-61. That's our largest lead. Cavs up 12. Largest lead, 73-61. We're playing amazing defense. Albany had a drive into the lane, and Sean Daniels blocked it. Sean Fountain run down the lane for them. Has to kick it high left for Neely. Dump it off baseline left. And another defensive turnover. The Cavs have just forced them into a turnover again with phenomenal defense. A travel. Side out, left sideline. Cavs by 12 with the ball. Final 3:55 of the third quarter. What a defensive effort for Lawton-Fort Sill. D'Anthony Bowden, high left, loop it halfway up the block on the left side to Sean. Backing. They're not doubling. Sean, take Harvey Thomas to the glass. Give it to Ellis. Back to Sean. Nine to shoot. Sean looks at the shot clock. Says, I'm going to the glass. He shoots. Won't go. D'Anthony Bowden gets the rebound. We could run more time off the clock, and we will. Cavs are going to run time off the clock. Brandon Dean, almost to the center jump circle. Gets a pick from Sean coming high and dribbles it. Out of bounds, last touch by Fountain. Cavs get a break. They're going to try to return Mike Campbell to the game. Derek Rowland will, the coach of the Albany Patroons. Derek Rowland, of course, at the beginning of last year, was Michael Ray's assistant in Oklahoma. This is D'Anthony Bowden. Run inside. Kick it. Mims, another three. Boom! Alvin Jalen Mims is having a night and a half. The Cavs are up 76-61. They run. Bank shot does not go down for Gabe Freeman. Elvin Mims, very, very atypical, if you will, for him to shoot threes. He doesn't shoot many threes. I'll go back to the season statistics. If I've got a break, I'll go back and look at all of his numbers. Very rare for Elvin to do that. Gabe Freeman makes a free throw. Let's see. Before we got into the playoffs, Elvin Mims, 1 of 6 through our first 10 games, he was just 1 of 6 from three-point range. They just got 2 free throws for Freeman. Cavs have the ball, up by 13. 3 minutes left, third quarter. Sean playing a two-man game with DeAnthony Bowden. Sean still has it, 9 to shoot. Halfway up the block on the left side. Sean, go to the glass, spin. Sean, they tip the ball away. That was a nice defensive play by Sullinger. They are running, it's Freeman. Fouled by Elvin Mims, and that's a good call. That's a good call. Before the shot, it should have been before the shot. There's the automatic timeout, 2:46 left, third quarter. Michael came out onto the floor and was yelling at the official, saying that call should have been before the shot, but we get no satisfaction there. Cavs' largest lead now, let me check, was 15. I'm altering. I always try to keep track of the largest advantage. Cavs' largest lead had been 76-61. They pushed it up to 76-63 with those 2 free throws. Wow. Lawton-Fort Sill has the 76-63 advantage. We always brag about you're listening to Magic 95, and this is going to be one of the final times that I am able to say this, but Chuck Morgan, and I'm sure he's listening, the general manager at Magic 95, and of course Al Young, who just works with me tirelessly, and Johnny Blaze and the people that have helped us, Magic 95 has always believed in the Cavs, and we thank them. Today's best music, Magic 95. You know, we've got a new cutting-edge way for you to contact us by text. Send us your requests, birthdays, anniversaries, or listener comments to 919-1313. Our text line powered up by Cellular Sales, your Verizon-authorized retailer on Cash Road and in Central Mall. And, of course, Magic 95 loves to help you celebrate your wedding anniversary with a free prize package that'll help you and your spouse rekindle the flame when you or somebody you know is celebrating another year of wedded bliss. Make sure we know about it. Boogie and Indy will announce wedding anniversaries every Friday morning. One lucky couple will win our prize package containing gifts from Lawton Floral, Mike's Sports Grill, and Super Video Plus. Listen for wedding anniversaries every Friday morning. Boogie and Indy. Tomorrow morning, 6 to 10. Monday morning, start your week off right. Tune in to Boogie and Indy Show every weekday morning. 6 to 10, the Hollywood buzz, strange and useless news, the birthdays, doggone and cat too. Anniversaries on Fridays. Magic 95, I tell you, they are a major part of Lawton, and their support of the Cavs this year, we really tip our hat. Well, Freeman's been living at the free throw line. He makes another. Fouled before that last stoppage of play. Misses one. He finally misses one. Cavs are up by 12, 76-64. The defensive rebound of the missed free throw for Ellis. We go to the final 2:35 of the third quarter. We're trying to spread the floor. They're in a zone. Bowden looking for Tim Ellis. He finds Sean. Sean to Ellis, right side. 6 to shoot, 5 to shoot. We're trying to take as much time on each possession. Back to Bowden. Take a three. DeBow missed it again. DeBow cannot buy a three. DeAnthony Bowden. Boy, if he could heat up, we're going crazy. Fountain go coast to coast for them and score. Sean Fountain has 5 points. He just went coast to coast. After Bowden missed, Sean Fountain got the rebound. Eddie Smith's going to come in for DeAnthony Bowden. DeBow didn't cut off Sean Fountain. Cavs still lead by 10 in the final 2 minutes. What a feed! Sean Daniels to Elvin Mims. Sean was high right. Elvin Mims got a back cut through the lane. Nobody covered Elvin Mims. He caught it, jammed it home. Elvin Mims with 17 points, 10 rebounds. Cavs are up 12 again, 78-66. Final minute 40. Albany looks as if the wind going out of their sails a little bit. This is Campbell looking for Fountain, cutting the lane. Lays it up. Got it. Sean Fountain. What did Michael Ray say on my pregame interview? He said he is the engine that drives their car. He has not done much so far, but now he's got 7 points. He's gotten back-to-back buckets to try to keep them in the game. He's the only guy showing intensity for them. Debout, head of the lane, fake a three, still has it, nine to shoot. Ball tipped away. DeAnthony Bowden lost the ball again. Sullinger runs, Sullinger drive. Sullinger is fouled, and he scores. Wow. Cavs had an opportunity to really separate, and DeAnthony Bowden, a couple of mistakes. He is yanked unceremoniously from the ballgame. Eddie Smith is in there. Sullinger has 17 with a free throw coming. And that's a horrible free throw. That didn't have a prayer. 78-70. We're still up by eight, but the final minute of the third quarter, Michael just says, we get a big lead. You cannot let them get close. We've got to keep the separation. It's like a big race when you get out front. Ellis take a right wing jumper for the Cavs. Weak side rebound comes to Campbell. We didn't take enough time off the shot clock there. Michael's going to scream about that. Harvey Thomas at the other end. Run, shoot, miss, tip in, no. Sean Daniels got a defensive hand on that shot, and then he got the rebound. And Harvey, Albert White's going to come in momentarily. Eddie Smith, work inside to Sean, run the lane. Whistles had sounded early. Albany trying to get back in this thing. The Cavs' largest lead was 15 at 76-61, and it was starting to slip away a little bit. Michael yanks Tim Ellis out of the game. I told you, I thought Tim took a shot too quickly. And so he comes out. DeAnthony Bowden dropped the ball a minute ago. He comes out. Michael says this is it. He's not going to allow that. The beautiful part is that he's got some good players off the bench in Eddie and Albert White. Cavs 10 to shoot. Halfway up the block on the left side is Sean. Final 30 seconds, third quarter. Sean still has it. Give it Elvin Mims. Mims, drop step, shoot. Got it! Elvin Mims! Oh my goodness, what a game he is having. Elvin Mims has 19. Cavs are up 10 again at 80 to 70. Final 15 seconds of the third quarter. Are they going to take the final shot? It looks like they will. Albany will take the final shot now with 11 to shoot, 10 to shoot, 9 to shoot. Third quarter, Sullinger, head of the lane, working on Sean. Crossover dribble, run. He was fouled. Looked as if he carried the ball, says Michael Ray, but he'll get no satisfaction on that call. A couple of free throws on the docket for Sullinger. We'll annotate all the free throw shooting when we come back after our break between quarters three and four. 5 seconds left. We might get another shot. Sullinger, free throw. Got it. He has 18 points on the evening. Cavs have 5 seconds left. Will Michael call a timeout? You know, you'd like to put a dagger in him. It doesn't look like Michael's going to do it. He could call a timeout to advance the ball to midcourt. Sullinger got the next free throw. We're not going to do it. We're just going to have our regular set. 4 seconds left. Brandon Dean, 3 seconds. Take a three. Brandon! Oh, just missed. Just missed. What a dagger that would have been if that had gone down. Cavs go to the fourth quarter. Cavs go to the fourth quarter, leading 80 to 72. Our largest lead had been 15 at 76 to 61. Albany put on a nice little spurt to cut it to 8. They outscored us by 7 in the final 2 or 3 minutes of the third quarter. But we'll go to the fourth quarter with the Cavs up 8, 80 to 72. Your final 12 minutes of basketball for this season on the agenda. Who will win the CBA title? Stay tuned. Your Cavs come this way on Magic 95.
10 seconds, Chris.
Okay. Wow.
Statistics always tell the story. I've told you time and time again. All right, now listen to this. To start the game, you've got to do the math, Lawton. All of you in the Lawton, Fort Sill area, listening on Magic 95, all our webcasts as well. Do the math. The Cavs started the game, and we got 9 early free throws. The Cavs had 9 free throws, and they had just 1. All right, keep that in the back of your mind. Cavs had 9 free throws to start the game. They had just 1. Right now, we are 13 of 15 from the line, which means since that point, we've only gotten 6. And they are 23 of 26. They've got some maniac on a PA announcer here telling the crowd to get fired up while we've got the ball. Cavs lead it 80 to 72. We're in the fourth quarter. Brandon Dean, fake a shot, run right baseline, kick it high. Elvin Mims, another three. Got it! Elvin Mims has 22 points. We're almost trapping the ball at midcourt. We're up 83 to 72. Sullinger work inside, kick it to Campbell. He takes a three. Miss it! Rebound, Elvin Mims. Guess who? Superman. Elvin Mims is playing like Superman. We go to the final 11-10 of this game. Cavs are up by 11, 83 to 72. We are beating them at the three-point line. That's unusual. Brandon Dean to Elvin Mims to Eddie Smith. High right, run down the left of the lane. Eddie, put it up. Got it. Eddie Smith. Folgers off the bench. We've scored the first 5 points of the fourth quarter. Cavs are up 13, 85 to 72. They want to run. Shot blocked by Elvin Mims. They're going to call goaltending. Freeman will get credit for that, and I'm not happy about it, but I think probably that was a good call. 85 to 74. And they call a foul? Now that's a joke. That's a joke. Freeman completes the three-point play. ...85-75, Cavs by 10 with 10:45 left. Brandon Dean, high left. Now, don't get lulled into thinking we can win this game from the three-point line. Albert White is in. He's got it. He throws it out of bounds. What was that? Albert White thought Brandon Dean was going to cut baseline left, and he threw it 7 rows into the stands. Cavs have a 10-point lead in the final 10 and a half. Fourth quarter, this is the CBA title game. We've been playing superb defense. Gabe Freeman will run the lane. Off-balance shot is up. No good. Rebound. Albert White, and he throws it out of bounds again. Albert White threw it out of bounds again. The guys have got to play smarter. Albert White has made 2 just absolute bonehead plays. He knows I love him, so you can't, he knows I'm not bagging it, but you just got to come down and hold the ball with a 10-point lead. Every possession is just vital. Every possession is vital. Cavs up by 10 with 10:15 to go. Albany has dropped it out of bounds. They'll get a out-of-bounds play on the baseline. It was tipped away by the Cavs. 2 shots for Albany miss on their out-of-bounds play, and then Harvey Thomas tips it in. He's got 21. We're down to an 8-point lead at 85 to 77, and an offensive foul called on Albert White at the other end. He's coming out. Albert White has made 3 horrible plays in a row, and Darryl Crow will come in for Albert White. You come into a ball game like this with the CBA title on the line, you've got to use your head. You've got to be smart. Albert was frustrated. They got an offensive rebound over him. He'd thrown it away twice, and he committed a foul. So Albert White is out. Darryl Crow could be our savior here. We need him. Freeman, high left. Cavs still lead by 8. Freeman guarded by Sean. Backing. Will we go to double? No, they give it to Fountain. Sean Fountain runs the lane. Kick it high right. Campbell. Campbell stutter steps. 7 to shoot. Work it to Sullinger. He'll wheel. Fall away jumper. Ball tipped away. They call a foul on the Cavs, but that's all right. That's still great help defense. They call that on Brandon Dean. That was still wonderful help defense. Albany feels now they are going to try to peck away at this. The Cavs were up by 15. They are back to within 8, could be 6 if both free throws go down. Sullinger got the first. And the Cavs had the advantage by hitting 7 of 19 three-pointers. They were just 3 of 12. Sullinger got both free throws. The Cavs have been up 15. Now it's just 6. The Cavs have been up 15. And now it is 85 to 79. 9.5 to go. Fourth quarter. Got to be smart now. Sean Daniels. Low right. Give it to Daryl Crow. Just off the bench. Between the legs dribble. Ball tipped away from Daryl Crow. Last touch by Harvey Thomas. The crowd trying to influence that call that Crow had touched it last. If they had given them that call, I would have gone berserk. Cavalry ball. 6 to shoot. Eddie has it. Run the lane, Eddie. Spin. Put it up. He's fouled. He'll have free throws. Good move for Eddie Smith. Good move for Folgers. Instant offense off the bench. Eddie will have a couple of free throws. We have got to make free throws. This is it, folks. 9:20 left in the CBA season for the CBA title. Cavs have a 6-point lead. Eddie, free throw. Got it. Nice job, Eddie. Eddie's got 10 points. Brandon Dean has 13. Bowden's out of the game with 10. Elvin Mims has 22 with 3 threes. Eddie, another free throw. Got them both. Boy, those were vital. Ice water Folgers there. 87 to 79. Albany wants to up tempo. This is Gabe Freeman, isolated on the left side, working on Elvin Mims. Shoot. Got it. It took a good roll. Gabe Freeman has 16, 87 to 81. The Cavs by 6, under 9 to play. Fourth quarter, Eddie Smith. High right, find Brandon Dean. We isolate the entire right side for Brandon Dean. Working on Fountain. Brandon spin. They come to double. He reverses it to Eddie. Almost out of bounds. He was out of bounds. Another turnover. Another turnover against the Cavs. Oh, don't let this thing slip away. The Cavs had a 15-point lead. The Cavs had a 15-point lead. It's down to 6, and Albany's got the ball. We take a 60-second timeout, the automatic timeout, 8:45 left. Cavs, come your way on Magic 95. Thank you. Chris Needham, back with you live on the floor of the Washington Avenue Armory, Albany, New York. We go to the final 8:45 of this contest in the fourth quarter. We can't guarantee it won't be overtime. 8:45 left, fourth quarter. Lawton-Fort Sill, 87. Albany, 81. We had a 15-point lead. The Cavs, it really appeared to me we got a little bit lackadaisical. How can that be possible? But Albert White came in, made 3 straight mistakes. He's out of the ballgame. Daryl Crow's in there for him. DeAnthony Bowden made a couple of mistakes, so Eddie's in for him. Albany has the ball, 10 to shoot. Baseline right corner. Gabe Freeman looked as if he were pushing off on the baseline, trying to run right baseline against Elvin Mims. They called the foul on Elvin Mims. That is his 4th foul, and they are not in the bonus as of yet. They'll have a side out, 14 to shoot. They'll bring it in to Freeman. He'll run, hop step in the lane, shoot, got it. 4-point game. 4-point game. I don't believe it. It appeared like we were going to take control late third quarter, early fourth quarter, but The Cavs have let a 15-point lead slip away. Sean just tried on the left baseline to hit Eddie Smith running down the left of the lane. Tipped out of bounds by Freeman. Cavs have 13 to shoot. 8-10 left, fourth quarter. Out of bounds play on the baseline to the left of the bucket. Crow get it into Eddie Smith. Get a pick from Sean. Eddie, high left. Halfway up the block, left side to Sean, wheeling inside. Sean, go to the glass, shoot, miss it. Tip in, Darryl Crow does not go. They've got it. Albany, they could cut it to two. 87-83, Lawton-Fort Sill. Outside jumper. Goes a three for Sullinger. He's got 24. It is 87-86, 7.5 remaining. Eddie Smith doubled high right. We're letting this thing slip away. Eddie Smith, kick it to Mims, to Brandon. Take a three. Brandon does not go. They get the rebound. They have never led. Albany has never led in this basketball game. The Patroons have the ball down 87-86, 7:15 to go. Running drive for Sean Fountain. Ball doesn't go down. Knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Cavs. It's Albany basketball. 7:11 remaining. Cavs have the 87-86 advantage. But Albany has the ball on the baseline. Underneath the bucket, to the right of the bucket. They get a new shot clock. They'll bring it in to Freeman. Trying to get a pick now from Campbell. Outside jumper in the sky, doesn't go. Weak side rebound, Elvin Mims. Loose ball foul on Harvey Thomas. Cavalry ball, 7 minutes to play, 7 minutes to go, and the Cavs lead it 87-86. We have been up by 15. Eddie Smith up the left sideline. They are trying to play. Well, they're really playing a zone, you can tell. Albany has never led this basketball game. It's a one-point game. Darryl Crow, free throw circle jumper blocked by Freeman. And then they throw it away on the outlet. Sean Fountain got the ball and threw it away. We're going to get Albert White back into the ball game. We go to the final 6.5 of this one. And Sean is going to be called for... Now, Harvey Thomas is going to be called for fouling Sean Daniels. Albert White will come in for Darryl Crow. So Albert White came in a while ago, made three mistakes, and Darryl Crow replaced him. And now Albert White comes back in for Crow. Cavs have 16 to shoot, 6.5 to play, fourth quarter. Brandon Dean, low right, finding Sean. We isolate the entire right side for Sean. He spins, bounce it inside to White, lay it up. Got it! And he was fouled! And he was fouled! So Albert White gets the chance to redeem himself, and he does just that. Albert White came in a little while ago, made three mistakes, was yanked out of the ballgame. But Michael wanted him in there. He goes to the glass, he scores, was fouled, and makes the free throw! A big three-point play. It is 90-86. We go to the final 6:15 of this game. Freeman to Sean Fountain, around the horn, free throw line extended on the right side. Brandon Dean guarding Campbell, back to Sean Fountain, right back inside to Campbell, wheeling, spinning, back to Fountain, take a three, miss it, and a jam follow. A jam follow for Gabe Freeman. Wow. Does that set this crowd crazy? One-handed jam follow by Freeman. It's 90-88, 5:45 left. Eddie Smith, Cavs to Brandon Dean. To White, a three. Miss it. Cavs get the rebound. Albert White took a three. I can't believe that shot, but if it goes down, we look like a genius. Elvin take a three. Miss it. Sean get the rebound, but he tipped it to Sean Fountain. Sean Daniels tipped it to Sean Fountain. He'll run. Brandon stole the basketball. Please stay back, people. We got people coming out of the stands and jumping on top of me here. Brandon Dean working to Eddie Smith. Take a jumper, baseline left. Timeout on the floor. Boy, this crowd is berserk. We've got people, timeout on the floor, 5:17 to go. They have no control up here. People are running down onto the floor from the stands to my left here. Cavs still lead it 90-88, 5:17 to go. And these final 5:17 of this season are going to be mind-boggling. The Cavs, we're keeping our broadcast here during a timeout. The Cavs had a 76-61 advantage. Albany put on an amazing run. Let's see, at one point that would have been first an 11-4 run. Then we got it back up to 11 at 85-72. And from that point, 85-72, they have outscored us 16-5. So Albany has put on two wonderful spurts to get back in this game. The Cavs at one point up by 15, and Albany amazingly has never led this basketball game. The last time they had the opportunity, it was 87-86, and they had the basketball. They missed. We came down and got a three-pointer. And the Cavs led 90-86. Now it's 90-88. Well, I guess this is the way it should be. I wanted the Cavs to get up by 15 and push it up, and we'd coast home. You wanted to coast home for a CBA title. Pardon my French, but it ain't going to happen that way. This is going to be a struggle. We're going to go to the final 5:17, and it's going to be a battle. Two great coaches. Derrick Rowland, I was questioning some of his coaching decisions yesterday. But Derrick Rowland has pushed the right buttons. Michael, of course, is a genius in coaching. He's pushed a lot of buttons. And here we go. Elvin Mims, Eddie Smith, Sean Daniels, Albert White, Brandon Dean on the floor in crunch time. 5:17 to go, fourth quarter. Cavs have the ball and a two-point lead. We've never trailed, but a 15-point lead is down to two. Eddie with 14 to shoot. Two-man game with Sean. Halfway up the block on the left side. Into Eddie. Reverse layup. Blocked out of bounds. No. Blocked by Harvey Thomas. Eddie got it. Got it to Albert White. And Albert White just hit a triple. Albert White off the bench is showing why Michael put him back in there. We're up by 5, 93-88. Eddie's shot was blocked by Harvey Thomas. Eddie picked up the loose ball. Freeman at the other end. Shoots. Score. He got a long two. Freeman is the one guy that's killing us. He's got 22. Gabe Freeman with 22. It's 93-90. Albert White has hit two big shots off the bench. We get it to Sean. Guarded by Freeman. They double. Kick it to Elvin Mims. To White. Another three. Missed this one. Nice rebound for Eddie Smith, who boxed off Harvey Thomas. Oh, Eddie Smith. A point guard just boxed out 6'9 Harvey Thomas, got the rebound and was fouled. Loose ball foul. Harvey Thomas, free throws coming for Eddie. 4:25 left. Harvey Thomas was the one a minute ago that blocked Eddie's shot. Eddie got the rebound, got it to Albert White for the three. Just then, Eddie with a great defensive rebound. Free throw, Eddie got it. Oh, Eddie Smith. Eddie is 6 of 6 from the line tonight. Eddie Smith, make it 7 of 7, and we're back up 5. It's up. He got it. Eddie Smith makes it 95-90. Play defense now, guys. Albany wants to score quickly. Campbell, run, shoot, miss, air ball. Albert White picks it out of the sky. Give it Eddie. Slow it up. Slow it up. Control tempo, guys. We're going to go under 4 minutes on this possession. We're going to go under 4 minutes left, fourth quarter, on this possession. Cavs have the ball up 5. Elvin Mims to Eddie, high left. Halfway up the block, left side to Sean. Sean, 6 to shoot. Sean, feet inside, threw it out of bounds. Sean was looking for Eddie to cut. Eddie was being grabbed, he's saying. Eddie is yelling, he was being held. We turned it over. Lawton-Fort Sill, 95. Albany, 90. 3:55 left, fourth quarter. Up the right sideline is Freeman. Freeman working on Sean. We don't double. Sean, hand in his face. The shot doesn't go. The follow, Harvey Thomas. Nobody blocked off Harvey Thomas. He's got 23. Got the tip follow. 95-93. Harvey Thomas got the tip follow. Cavs have the ball. Cavs lead by 3. 3.5 left. Eddie Smith. Bounce pass to Sean. Knocked out of bounds by Freeman. Cavs have a side out. Left sideline. 13 to shoot. Mims the trigger man. Everybody tired now, too. You can tell that. Boy, we've been playing a lot of basketball. Three games in four nights. Who's in better shape? Who wants it? Brandon Dean has it. Run inside. Brandon. Goaltending! They missed a goaltending call. Brandon Dean laid it up. It was on the rim, tipped away. They missed a goaltending call. They go the other way. Mike Campbell scores. He's got 10. Cavs just got shafted. Cavs just got shafted. Cavs just got shafted. That was atrocious. They missed a goaltending call. Elvin Mims to Brandon. Take a three. Got it! Brandon Dean got the triple anyway. I can't believe it. We're playing seven guys. The Cavs are having to fight seven guys out there. They're five and the two officials. Cross-court pass, Freeman. Baseline left corner. Out of bounds! He dropped it out of bounds. The Cavs will have the ball in a four-point lead. The Cavs will have the ball in a four-point lead. That was the most atrocious missed call I've seen all year long. Brandon Dean just had a layup on the rim, and they knocked it off the rim, and they blew it. They turned their eyes away because they're in Albany. That was an absolute disgrace. And then we came down and got a three from Brandon anyway. Just how much of a professionalism does that show you for the Cavs? Cavs lead it 98-94, 2:48 left in the fourth quarter. This is the lineup that I think Michael wants to go with. Playing the defense, Eddie Smith doing the job as the point guard. Brandon Dean on the offside, getting the outside shots. Albert White in crunch time, Sean inside. This is the lineup I think Michael wants. We're keeping our broadcast right here. I don't blame them. I don't blame them. They've got their PA guy out there telling everybody to stand up, root Albany home. They've got the home court advantage. This is the CBA Championship Series, and they're letting Albany play all three games at home. We knew that. Of course it's not fair, but we go to the final 2:48, and they've got this home crowd going crazy. How sweet would it be for the Cavs to win anyway? What a big bucket that was a minute ago when the Cavs got robbed on a horrible call, and we came back and got a Brandon Dean three anyway. The Cavs have the ball in the final 2:45, up by four, 98-94. Eddie Smith, crossover dribble, bounce it to Sean, low left. They double. Bad pass! They steal. Freeman runs. Fouled by Elvin Mims. Sean got careless. Sean Daniels made a bad pass, stolen by Freeman. He went the length of the floor, fouled by Mims. Amazingly, we're not in the final 2 minutes and not in the penalty, so they don't get free throws. We can set up defense. Play good defense, guys. Cavs by four still, 98-94, 2.5 left, fourth quarter. Campbell, the trigger man, finding Freeman. He has killed us. Freeman's got the ball, and he has 22 points. High right, looking for Harvey Thomas. Fake a three, dribble closer, kick it. Campbell take a three. Miss it, rebound. Campbell got a layup, missed. Freeman tipped it in. Freeman is killing us. He's got 24, two-point game. 98-96, we didn't hustle. The Cavs didn't hustle for that first miss of the shot. Final 2 minutes. 2 minutes left. Eddie Smith, drive baseline left. Eddie inside, run, put it up, miss. Tip up, Albert White, no. Rebound loose, still loose. Eddie Smith jumps on top of it. Albany has the ball, called a timeout. Minute 54 left. Cavs up 98-96. Albany has never led. Isn't this amazing? Albany has never led this basketball game, and they will have the ball down two in the final minute 54. Again, I will not break away. Maybe just one more time, but we don't want to miss anything. We want to analyze as much as we can. If you're just joining us late, the Cavs led 76-61. Give Albany credit. They came back from a 15-point deficit to within 90-88. Actually came back to within 87-86, but they've never led. They didn't take the lead. We got a three-point play for Albert White. Amazingly, with a one-point lead, We had Brandon Dean run baseline right, lay it up. The ball was on the rim. They knocked it away. The officials turned their eyes away, didn't make the goaltending call. We stopped them at the other end, came down, and Brandon Dean hit a three-pointer. But the Cavs now are only up two at 98-96. Lawton-Fort Sill up by two, a minute 54 to go. We fall back defensively with that lineup I told you about. Elvin Mims, Albert White, Sean Daniels playing defense inside. The guard line is Eddie Smith and Brandon Dean. Gabe Freeman out on the floor, waving his hands around, getting the crowd excited. He has killed us. Gabe Freeman has 24 points. Sean Fountain into the forecourt. We got to get a defensive stop. Work it to Freeman, run inside, shoot, miss. Cavs get the rebound. I can't believe that Freeman threw up an off-balance shot like that, twisted his ankle. Cavs get the rebound. We go to the final minute 30 with the ball and a two-point lead. Mims to Brandon Dean. Brandon still with the basketball. They're in the zone. They're trying to keep us away from going inside. Mims has it, high right, back to Brandon. Brandon trying to penetrate. Works, shoots, misses. They get the rebound. Final minute 20. Cavs are up 98-96. Fountain has it. Free throw line extended on the right wing. Working on Eddie Smith. Offensive foul! Offensive foul! Offensive foul! Eddie Smith! Eddie Smith did a great defensive job cutting off Sean Fountain. Fountain called for the offensive foul. How can we be mad at the officials making that call? We're down to the final minute 10. Cavs have the ball and a two-point lead. Cavs have the ball and a two-point lead. A minute remaining. 1 minute left, fourth quarter. Albert White, high right, high left, find Eddie. Eddie right back to Albert White. Inside to Sean. Sean spin, give it to Brandon Dean. Six to shoot, five to shoot. Back to Sean, three to shoot. Back cut, Albert White, layup. Albert White scores. Albert White scores. Cavs by four in the final 45 seconds. They're not calling a timeout. Fountain, take a three. Miss it. Rebound, Harvey Thomas. Baseline left jumper. Harvey Thomas trying to back in on Mims. Shot in the sky. Too strong. They called a foul on Harvey Thomas. I'm sorry. They called a foul on Elvin Mims on Harvey Thomas. What have they called? They called a technical. That is Elvin Mims playing with six fouls. That's what it is. And they missed the free throw. Elvin Mims has to be in there. But if you play with six fouls and you commit a foul, it's a technical. They missed the technical free throw in a four-point game in the final 33 seconds of the CBA title game. Amazing. But Harvey Thomas was fouled by Elvin Mims. Big free throws for Harvey Thomas, 100-96. And he missed the free throw! Crucial, crucial crunch time, and Harvey Thomas, their leading scorer, misses a free throw. The next is up. He got that. Cavs have the ball on a three-point lead. Eddie Smith spinning away from a double in the backcourt. 25 seconds to play. Eddie almost throws it away. He does. Campbell steals. He runs and puts it up. 1 point game. Eddie threw it away. It is 100-99 in the final 20 seconds. Eddie lost it again. Fountain to Thomas. Thomas jams it home. Albany leads. Albany leads. The Cavs have lost the ball on back-to-back trips. Brandon Dean with the ball in the final 10 seconds. Give it to Elvin Mims. The Cavs, 6 seconds to play. We're down by 1 point, and Sullinger fouls Albert White. Amazing that the Cavs had a 100-96 lead, and Eddie Smith threw it away on back-to-back possessions. Eddie Smith threw it away on back-to-back possessions. We're going to get Tim Ellis into the game. Albert White was fouled. Free throw, Albert. Missed it. 101-100. Albany leads 101-100. Albany has their first lead of the game, 101-100. and the crowd trying. Albert White has another free throw to tie. Got it. We're tied. They're not going to call a timeout. We're tied at 101. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. Ball knocked out of bounds. I can't believe they're not calling a timeout. Now they do. The game is tied at 101 with 2.6 seconds left. The game is tied at 101 with 2.6 seconds remaining. Albany will have a side out in the forecourt with a chance to win the game with 2.5 seconds. The Cavs can't foul. Got to play defense. The Cavs have this game won. We were up 100-96 in the final 30 seconds. The Cavs were up 100-96 in the final 30 seconds. And Eddie Smith lost the ball two times in a row. We had a follow for Harvey Thomas for a score, and we had Sean Fountain steal it on an out-of-bounds play for a score. And they took the lead after a free throw. 101-100. Then Albert White hit a free throw, one of two, and we're tied at 101. 101 with 2.6 seconds remaining. Absolute bedlam. Absolute bedlam here. Can the Cavs force another overtime? Can we take them to overtime again? They're actually going to bring it in the backcourt. You've got to explain this to me. They're going to bring it in the backcourt. 2.6 seconds left. Can we get a stop? Go to overtime. They bring it to Harvey Thomas. A three near the buzzer. It's up. Missed it. We're going to overtime. We're going to overtime. We're going to overtime. We're still alive. We're still alive. We're still alive. Oh, my goodness. Overtime. I can't breathe. We're tied at 101. We're going to another overtime. That's the good news because they had a chance to win it. How they didn't get off a better shot than that and take it out at half court, I don't know. But we've got Elvin Mims playing with six fouls. That's why that technical free throw was so important a little while ago. But the two miscues by Eddie Smith. Oh, my goodness. I know Eddie wants to be the hero in overtime because we had a 100-96 advantage under 33 seconds to play, and we lost the ball twice. My goodness. We're going to the second overtime in a row. Last night, we were tied at 104 at the end of regulation. At the end of regulation, the Cavs were 36 of 77 from the floor, 10 of 23 from three-point range, 19 of 22 from the line. They are 27 of 32 from the line. They've gotten 10 more free throws. The Cavs are 10 of 23 from three-point range, and they're only 4 of 16 from three-point range. That's a dichotomy. They love the threes. Michael doesn't like to live and die by the outside jumpers. On the game, the Cavs shooting at 47%. On the games, Albany shooting at 47%. We have 17 assists to their 7 assists. Well, their crowd not as big as last night when they had almost 2,000, but they're making a lot of noise. We go to the first 5-minute overtime. Hopefully, it's the only one if we can win this thing. The Cavs have let this thing sort of slip away. Tip is controlled by the Cavs. Eddie Smith stays in there. Eddie is still the point guard with Brandon Dean, Sean Daniels, Albert White, Tim Ellis. Eddie, bounce it to Sean, working on Freeman. Left low block. Go to the paint. Sean against a double. Lay it up. Shot blocked. Harvey Thomas always comes from the weak side. Harvey Thomas is always coming from the weak side to block the shots. That's how we got the back cut for Albert White on the lay-in a little while ago. Eddie off the out-of-bounds play. Get it to Sean. Fake up. Or to Albert White. Pop a jumper. Got it! Albert White! He's been our guy late in the game. He's got 22. Cavs lead 103-101. Cavs up. 30 seconds gone into overtime. 103-101. They'll work it to Harvey Thomas. Working on Sean. Left wing. Sean says, I dare you to try to cut to the back. There's shot clock just now. Going to 23 seconds. This is a travesty. It is amazing how they keep letting them get the shots. Now the officials finally notice it. They had taken 10 seconds and the shot clock still read 22 seconds. They've done that 7 or 8 times tonight. The officials finally are noticing it. They're giving them extra time. Now, the Cavs have Patroons have 13 to shoot. They'll bring it in. Almost a steal by Albert White, and he calls he committed a foul on J.J. Sullinger. It'll be a side out with 14 to shoot on the side out for Albany, unless they decide to give them 30 seconds on the shot clock. So 14 to shoot. Now they bring it in, 10 to shoot. Cavs are up 103-101, 4:15 to play in the fourth quarter. Harvey Thomas at the head of the lane working on Ellis. Ellis stole the ball. Eddie Smith has it. Eddie will run. Eddie will lay it up. Miss it. Tip up. Goes for Albert White. Albert White has 24. We got a good fast break opportunity there. The Cavs are up 105-101. Eddie Smith redeemed himself a little bit there. He tried to lay it up. It was sort of a finger roll coming off the iron, and Albert White put it down. Sean Fountain, baseline right. Work it to Sullinger. Shot goes for him. J.J. Sullinger has 26. 105-103. 3:40 left. We're in the first overtime. Lawton-Fort Sill, 105-103. 3.5 to play. Eddie Smith getting a pick from Sean. High right to Albert White, to Brandon Dean. Brandon Dean to Albert White, a three! Miss it. They get the rebound. They could tie or take the lead. Sean Fountain up the right sideline. 3:20 to play in overtime. Cavs playing defense, up by 2. Campbell work inside. Reverse layup. Knocked out of bounds. Everybody's screaming they should have called a travel. No satisfaction there. They've got 14 to shoot. Out of bounds play on the baseline for Albany to the right of the bucket. 3:15 to play. They get it to Campbell looking for Harvey Thomas low. Campbell working on Brandon Dean. Cavs almost make a steal. And they call Brandon Dean for a foul. It'll be a side out for Albany. 3:10 left in overtime. Boy, it's who's in shape now. Who wants it now? Because you can tell the players, some of these guys are sucking wind. Sean Fountain has played the whole game. We've had a lot of our guys play a bunch of minutes. Fountain has the ball, 10 to shoot, 3 minutes left in overtime. Fountain working on Eddie Smith, 7 to shoot, 6 to shoot to Campbell. Brandon Dean's on him, working inside Harvey Thomas. Albert White stole it! Albert White stole it! Albert White made an amazing steal. We're under 3 minutes to play. Cavs have the ball in a 2-point lead. Albert White in overtime has come up big. Brandon Dean looking for Sean. Sean comes out high to get the ball. We've got 9 to shoot, 8 to shoot to Eddie, 7 to shoot, 6 to shoot. Eddie on the right wing. We isolate. Eddie, 3 to shoot. Eddie, got to shoot quickly. Jumper up. Eddie, good! Good! Got it! Eddie has 15. Cavs by 4. 2:25 left in overtime. Fountain goes coast to coast. Dribbles between a double. Right here, they're going to call the foul on Eddie Smith, which was a good call. 2:24 left in overtime. Lawton-Fort Sill, your Cavs are winning in overtime. 107-103. Cavs by 4. 2:24 left overtime. We let it slip away in regulation. Don't do it again. Harvey Thomas has the ball. Left wing working on Sean. Spinning. Sean, good defensive effort. Thomas misses. Loose ball in the lane. Freeman was fouled. But that was a wonderful defensive series right there for Sean Daniels. He knocked Harvey Thomas off of his attempted shot. The ball came down weak side, loose in the lane. They called a foul, and Freeman will have a couple of free throws. He's been their hero. He's got 24 and has been near perfect from the line. He missed one just a second ago. Freeman, free throw. Got it. He's got 25. 2:12 left. The Cavs still lead by 3, 107-104. Freeman, another free throw to make it a 2-point game. It's in the sky. Got it. Cavs have the ball in the final 2:10. 2:10 remaining. Cavs 107, Albany 105. We're in overtime. Albert White, high, stutter step. They are not allowing us to really work inside, and the Cavs are relying on a lot of outside shots. Now we go baseline right low to Albert. Drop step, fall away jumper, doesn't go. Nice weak side rebound. Sean tipped away. Sean got the ball. They tipped it away. Albany's got it. They could tie or take the lead. 1:45 left. Sean Fountain between the circles looking for Harvey Thomas to set a pick on the right wing. He does. Fountain fake a shot. Give it Campbell. Campbell dogged by Brandon Dean, Campbell, run inside. We come to double. They'll get it. Harvey Thomas take a three. Got it. No, it doesn't count. It doesn't count. Was he out of bounds? He was standing out of bounds. A turnover. He was standing out of bounds when he caught the basketball. Timeout, Cavs. Timeout, Cavs. I'm pausing to listen to Michael. He says just a 20, just a 20-second timeout. A minute 33 remaining. We're in overtime. The game was knotted up at 101 when we ended regulation. The Cavs had let a 15-point lead at 76-61 slip away. Albany had never taken a lead until late, and then they did lead for the first time at 101-100. Eddie Smith, late in regulation, made a couple of mistakes and allowed a 100-96 lead slip away. We got an Albert White free throw to tie it and send it to overtime at 101. Then Albert White has been big in overtime. He's got 24 points on the game. Elvin Mims is out of the game with 22 points because he's got six fouls, and he can't play in a tight game like this because if he makes a foul, you can play in the CBA, but it's a technical foul if you do. So we've got Ellis, Albert White, Eddie Smith, Brandon Dean, Sean Daniels. The Cavs will have a side out in the backcourt, left sideline, a minute 33 to play. What did Michael set up during that timeout? Cavs lead the game by two, 107-105. How vital a score would be on this trip. We've got to score on this trip. Cavs by two, a minute 25 left, minute 24. Eddie Smith, bounce it low left block to Sean. Will they double? Kick it, Brandon. Fake a three, find Albert White. Takes a long three. Good! It's not a three, just a two. Albert White. Albert White got the deuce, 109-105. Has he been big in overtime? We go to the final minute five. Sean Fountain dribbled between a double team. And they call Eddie Smith at the head of the lane for the foul, which is all right. He was one of the guys doubling Fountain. And as he dribbled between the double team, of a pick set by Harvey Thomas, they called the foul. A couple of free throws now for Sean Fountain. A minute seven left. Cavs are up 109-105. Fountain usually is money. He misses one. I'm telling you, they've missed some big free throws. Sean Fountain stays at 7 points. The Cavs, even if he makes this one and nothing untoward happens, we should have a three-point lead in the final minute of overtime. 109-105, another free throw. Got it. So it is 109-106. The Cavs have the ball and a three-point lead in the final minute. A bucket here. If we could get up by five in the final minute, wow. This is Sean Daniels, low left block, wheeling. They're not doubling. He's going to the glass. Sean, head fake, shots up. No. Battling for the rebound. They've got it. It's Freeman, almost tied up. That was not a good look. They're coming up the floor quickly. This is Sullinger going baseline left, running. Shot blocked by Brandon Dean. And they called a foul on Brandon Dean. What would you expect? A clean block, it appeared, but we're not going to get that call now. 42 seconds left in overtime, but just two free throws for Sullinger, so we will still have a lead in the final 42 seconds, even if he makes two. Sullinger free throw is up. Missed it! I'm telling you, they are really blowing it from the free throw line. Albany really blowing it from the line. 42 seconds left in overtime. The Cavs 109, Albany 106. Another free throw is up. He got this. The Cavs will have a two-point lead. Be careful now. Bringing it up the floor. Lawton-Fort Sill 109, Albany 107. 35 seconds left in overtime. A score here would be vital, but we're not being able to penetrate inside. We're going to take as much time as possible. 10 seconds left. Shot clock, 25 left. Game clock. Brandon Dean. High left, looking for Sean. Get it to the head of the lane to Eddie. Five to shoot, four to shoot. Brandon, long jumper. Way strong, way strong. They've got it. They could tie. 16 seconds left. This is Campbell. Run inside. Dump it off. Ball tipped free. Sean Daniels knocks it out of bounds. 9 seconds left. 8.9, actually. 8.9 left. Will Albany call a timeout to set up a three to win this thing? You know, they could win it with a three. If they miss, the Cavs could win it. It comes down to this, the CBA championship. Timeout on the floor. It comes down to this, the CBA title for this season. Lawton-Fort Sill 109, Albany 107, 8.9 seconds left in overtime. Albany will probably try to go for a two. If they score and tie it, we go to another overtime. They could think, well, we could win it with a three. That would be gambling. We'll just let it play out. Amazing if the Cavs could dodge a bullet, having to play three games of a title series on the opponent's home floor, then letting a 15-point lead slip away, and then being up by four in the final 30 seconds and not being able to hold on. The Cavs have gotten some great opportunities in overtime. Darryl Crow is going to check in now. We'll see for whom in just a second. Your situation is we're in the first overtime, 8.9 seconds left. Cavs 109, Albany 107. Albany will try to take a shot. Do they go for two to tie? Do they go for three to win? Your percentages say at home you got a chance to win it. Take a long outside shot, maybe get a rebound and a putback for the tie. That is a lot of coaches' philosophy. All right, it is Darryl Crow, Sean Daniels, Brandon Dean, Eddie Smith, and Tim Ellis. So Darryl Crow came in for Albert White, who played superbly in this ballgame. Best game Albert White has ever had, obviously, in his very short Cav career. 26 points unofficially. Well, this short timeout has developed into two timeouts. They're going to take it in the backcourt. They want it in the backcourt to have room to maneuver. The Cavs need to play defense. Get a steal. Get a stop. Here we go. The final 8.9 seconds, maybe, of this season. The Cavs are up two. Albany could win with a three. Send it to overtime with a two. Sean Fountain has it into the forecourt, guarded by Eddie. Fake left, go right. He wants it to. No, it's a three. Harvey Thomas missed it. Get the rebound. Cavs are going to win. Cavs have the title. Cavs have the title. Cavs win. Cavs win. Now, wait a minute. Have they said more time on the clock? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Let's see. The clock says zero. The clock says zero. The clock says zero. They've put 1 second back. They've put 1 second back. The Cavs with now 0.6 left. 0.6 left. Well, they got it into Harvey Thomas's hands. They got it into Harvey Thomas's hands. He had a three at the buzzer. It didn't go. Cavs get the rebound. Michael calls a timeout. 0.6 left. Now, anything could happen. The clock went to zero. The clock went to zero, but the Cavs will bring it in. They will foul immediately. Then, now they say just 0.4 seconds left. I'm standing across the way. Some of our Cavs supporters, John Zelps, Mike Brown, are standing. Now they say just 0.4 seconds. So if the Cavs bring it in and they foul, that should be the ball game. Michael Ray is still orchestrating people out there. The Cavs are able to bring it because of the time. Now they say 0.5 seconds. Make up your mind. Make up your mind. All right, bring it in. They're going to foul immediately. Make sure you don't have a violation on the bringing the ball in. Sean will get it to Ellis. Shoot at the buzzer. Cavs win! Cavs win! Cavs win! Cavs win! Cavs win! The Cavs have won the CBA championship. The Cavs have won another CBA title. The Cavs have won another CBA title. The Cavs have done it. Eddie, let's get Albert first. We're going to get everybody over here now.
Albert! Come here!
We'll get you first, then Albert. We'll get everybody. Michael Ray Richardson to my immediate left. You talk about dodging bullet after bullet after bullet and just all the things that could go wrong did go
hearts
wrong.
Hearts of a champion.
There you go.
Heart of a champion. That's what it is.
Heart of a champion.
Hey, we know how to win the big ones.
We thought it wouldn't be.
I tell you, we made some mistakes, but what was amazing to me is that we had guys make mistakes, then come back on the floor and redeem themselves.
That's what you do. That's what champions do.
Albert
Look,
White.
This is for Lawton. This is for Lawton, Oklahoma. This one. Hey, you might as well keep that in Lawton. That stays in Lawton.
They just yeah. brought out the trophy.
Yeah.
Can you believe what Albert White did in overtime?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Thanks for the drink.
Hey,
yeah.
getting so much congratulations. Get your congratulations. Let me talk to Albert and then come back. This party's over. Let me talk to Albert and then you come back. Albert, get over here. We want to talk to everybody. Way to go, big guy. Way to go, big guy. Let's talk to Albert White first, and I'll get statistics here in just a minute. Your Lawton-Fort Sill Cavs have won the CBA title 109-107, late fourth quarter. Albert White comes in, and you won't mind that I say a couple of bonehead plays, threw it away one time, made a bad mistake, and unceremoniously, Michael Ray yanks you out of the ball game to the bench. 2 minutes later, he puts you back in, and Albert White, you won. Everybody contributed, but you were the man in the fourth quarter. Redeeming yourself had to feel so good.
Oh, yeah, I mean, it definitely felt great, but it just goes to show you what type of team we have. Guys always believe in each other, and, you know, if I'm out there open, they still kick it to me. So, you know, I got to give a lot of thanks and a lot of credit to the guys. You know, they play extremely hard.
You know, we led by 15 early, played the best defense I think we played all year long.
Exactly. Exactly. But, you know, this is a championship game, and nobody's going to quit. So, you know, everybody put it on the line, and, you know, we put it on the line. I felt like we wanted it more, and guys showed it, and we came out here with the victory.
You know, to come off the bench after you made a couple of mistakes and just stand there and hit a three-pointer, that's ice water in the veins right there. You had to feel so proud of yourself there.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, you know, that's why Coach brought me in. He knew I was a pretty good shooter from the outside, but, you know, it's a lot of other things I could do. But it all starts with guys believing in you, you know. I only been here like a week and a half, almost 2 weeks, and I just got to give a shout-out to the guys just for believing in me, you know.
Your line tonight, you know, you had 12 points at halftime in 9 minutes, but your line tonight, 10 of 18 from the floor, 3 of 8 from three-point range, 4 of 5 from the free throw line, 27 points, 5 rebounds. I mean, you talk about big time. I'm proud of you. Here's another guy proud of you, John Zelps. And we're going to, hey, being part of this family, you could feel that family situation, couldn't you?
Without a doubt. I mean, you know, this organization, you know, it's a class act, and I'm just glad to be a part of it. You know, they won it last year, you know. I'm just glad I was able to get me one this year.
Go get Brandon Dean for me, will
okay,
you? Thank you. Brandon's right there. Brandon, come here. Brandon. Brandon Dean coming here as well. Does it get sweeter one year to the next as far as a title? Last year, a full season going up to Minot. This was just a short season, but so many obstacles we had to overcome. Brandon Dean, back-to-back championship rings with the Cavs, and you have a feeling for Lawton, the people here, the Seegers and everything.
Well, you know what? As difficult as this season was, this is so rewarding for all these guys and the organization and the fans, because it was one of those unexpected seasons that nobody wanted to go through. But for the guys to come out here on the road and play 3 games in the championship series after being the number one team in the league, that shows a lot about the character of these guys on the team and the organization.
You know, you could just say, we got to play a championship, 3 games on the road and mope and complain. Hey, you guys just tended to business.
Well, the thing about it is that we have a lot of guys that's been here before, me, Sean, and DeAnthony, and I think we weathered the storm throughout all obstacles, whether it be calls, whether it be staying in a hotel all weekly and long. A lot of things we had to come overdo, and it's just a tremendous win for us.
Calls? What calls? Where Brandon...
I want to say hi to my baby Kimberly. I love you.
That's Michael Ray.
Wow.
I started to say, calls? What call? You put a layup on the rim, they knock it off the rim and don't call goaltending. That was the worst no call I think I have ever seen in my life, and that happened all night long, but you guys fought through it.
You know, the funniest thing...
Matter of fact, you came right back down the floor and hit a three.
Yeah.
You hit a three right after that.
The funniest thing about it was I asked him about it, and he said he didn't see the guy hit the ball. I said, I'm going to be the worst layup shooter in the world. So, but you know what? We're taking it back home, and we're happy, and we're excited to bring it back to life.
Go get Sean for me, will you?
All right.
Thank you, Brandon. What a class act, Brandon Dean. And Mary and Lester Seeger are up here, and they adopted Brandon Dean, and the arena is empty. Oh, way to go, Sean. Sean, I just wanted to get Sean Daniels over here, and I couldn't because they just gave him the most valuable trophy award. Is that what that is? You got to love that. And where's Elvin? Get over here, Sean. Then we'll get Elvin in here, too. Sean Daniels. My goodness. Let's look at this line. 13 points, 5 rebounds, but more than anything else, it is simply fighting through adversity. I mean, you know, the whole week up here, playing on their floor, things like that, just amazing.
Oh, yeah, it's just been tough. I mean, a few of us knew the situation after the last game against Minot, but, you know, a couple guys didn't know. So, I mean, we knew what we had to do, but we didn't know the full extent of it until we got
there. Hey, I want to talk to you, but they're taking pictures. I don't want you to miss that. Get in those pictures. Get Sean over here. Get Sean in that picture. I'm going to stay on the air live here, but they're taking a team picture with the owners and the trophy, and I didn't want Sean to miss that. And they're letting Lester and Mary of Landmark Engineering get in the team picture with the championship trophy. I tell you, that is something. This is a family affair, and I didn't want Sean to miss that. I didn't want Sean to miss that. Now we'll get Sean back there. Eddie, you come in. You come in too. Eddie, come too right here after we talk to Sean. You know, in the hall last night, DeAnthony saying they're sort of chicken. You know, they're playing a zone. They're not letting us get inside. They weren't letting you go to the bucket late in the contest, but we still did it. A couple of back cuts for Albert and good passes there, but just things that they took away. We had answers for them, didn't we?
Yeah, we really last night really got frustrated a little bit and kind of let that defense that they were playing on us get to us. And you know, we had a lot of vet guys. You know, me, Brandon, DeAnthony coming back from last year. You know, Albert coming in. I mean, he played a great game today. You know, I mean, he was knocking down shots for us. And when you're in that zone, you really need somebody to knock down shots for you to open it up for me on the inside. And he did a great job. I mean, I didn't really get going too much in the second half, but you know, coaches stayed with me and the guys just, you know, kept fighting. I mean, we had a scare there, you know, at the end of the regulation, but you know, the fight that we had. I mean, the stuff that we've been through all week being up here, and just, you know, guys just really wanted it. You know, for the young guys that have never got one, and you know, veteran guys that hadn't got one, we wanted to get it for them. You know, the owners, you know, they've been great to us, you know, doing the things they do for us and just keeping our heads focused on what we had to do. I mean, we could have tanked it and said, you know, we can't play at home and just gave up. But, you know, we kept fighting.
He just got the Gatorade shower right there. Brandon Dean just dumped some water on.
We had absolutely no quit in us, though. I mean, we kept fighting. I mean, we really did. You know, Brandon carried us. You know, DeAnthony, you know, that first game, I mean, that was just great. I mean, just that game, we had absolutely nothing going but him. I mean, he was really got it going for us. And, you know, coach just, you know, just staying on us, you know, keeping us focused.
All right, big guy, thank you. I got to dry off your microphone. I think he just put a bunch of water on the microphone here. I don't know if that's going to affect it or not. See if we got a chance to talk to Eddie. Eddie. Brandon just gave Sean a Gatorade water shower over the headset, so I think he might have hurt that microphone. We'll talk and see. Sounds all right, I think. Hey, I know you're happy because, hey, you're rolling your eyes. At the end of regulation, you turned it over twice, and you had to be thinking, what in the world? And yet, you know, you showed some moxie in coming back from that late.
Yeah, I got a great group of teammates. They just told me to keep my head up, and they needed me to finish this game out. The plays were made, and you just go back and change them, so you just got to keep playing.
Just got to, you know, that's the whole thing. And that's what we've done all year long, having to play 3 games up here on the road and things like that. You guys just sucked it up.
Yeah, it was real difficult. They got a great crowd. We thought that we could beat them, but they made it a run. They did what a team does. They tried to win. They didn't let us take it. We had to work for everything that we got.
And still did it. Way to go, big guy. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, had to turn that up loud. I think it was funny, but
Chris, Al, that mic is messed up.
It's gone. So we were trying to do our post-game interviews, but Brandon Dean dumped a bunch of water over Sean Daniels' head in celebration, and I think it ruined our microphone, which is all right. We got to talk to just about everybody, so that'll wrap it up. Let's get you all the final statistics here. Cavs win. That is a back-to-back CBA titles for your Lawton-Fort Sill Cavs to come up here. Some of the officiating calls the guys were screaming about, but as I told you, the things evened out. What it was just, hey, we made some mistakes late. Eddie, I was glad to at least that we could hardly hear him, but he redeemed himself. We had a 196 lead late in the contest, and he threw it away, let them get it to overtime, but Albert White stepped up big in overtime. So for the ball game, now that we've got all the final statistics, the Cavs end up shooting at 46%, 40 of 87. They were 36 of 87. The Cavs were 10 of 24 from three-point range, 19 of 22 from the line. Boy, was that vital. We were not a good free-throw shooting team for the majority of the year, but when it came down to crunch time, 19 of 22 from the line, and on the road, we had 22 free throws. They gave them 38 free throws. They were 31 of 38, and the Cavs still won it. We lost the rebounding battle, 44 to 41. Albany wins that battle. Final score, Cavs win it, 109 to 107. I'm looking at other numbers. They had only 8 assists for the entire 53 minutes of basketball. We had 17 assists and 23 turnovers. Boy, that was a big factor, and it shows they do an awful lot of one-on-one basketball, and we had to play tight, help man defense, and did a great job in that regard. The Cavs at 46% from the floor, they were at 47%. The Cavs, 10 of 24 from three-point range. They were 4 of 17 from three-point range, and we contested some of their outside shots. That was a big factor. They were led by Gabe Freeman with 26, Harvey Thomas with 26, J.J. Sullinger with 27. All the numbers for your CBA Championship Cavs. DeAnthony Bowden had 10 points, 3 of 10 from the floor, 5 rebounds. Brandon Dean ends up with 16 points, 6 of 15 from the floor, 4 of 8 from three-point range, had 4 assists and 3 turnovers. Tim Ellis ends up with 2 points. Elvin Mims, a double-double. Elvin Mims, 22 points, 11 rebounds, 9 of 11 from the floor, including for Elvin Mims, 3 of 3 from three-point range, which were for him was very unusual. That's why we got up by 15, and then they took that away from us, obviously. Sean Daniels, 6 of 13 from the floor, ends up with 13 points, 5 rebounds. Eddie Smith had I'm laughing because he turned it over twice late in the game. We made a big deal about that, and they've got him down for one turnover. We'll take that. Eddie Smith ends up with 15 points and 3 rebounds. Courtney Williams played, did not score. Darryl Crow had 4 points. I'll tell you, the star of the game was Albert White. We talked to him on the postgame show in only 23 minutes. In only 23 minutes, Albert White had 27 points, 5 rebounds, 10 of 18 from the floor, 3 of 8 from three-point range, 4 of 5 from the line. And that wraps it up. The Cavs are your CBA champions again. We want to thank Big Al Young. Boy, we had to go through a lot tonight, and I apologize that we had a microphone just absolutely blow up on us because we got Sean was being interviewed, and Brandon came up and just threw a bunch of water on him, and that killed the microphone. But Al Young, we'll give that back to you when we come back to Lawton. Al Young did a great job tonight, our in-studio producer all season long. Johnny Blaze has helped us as well. General Manager Chuck Morgan at Magic 95. Boy, we thank all you people for your support. Michael was my guest on the pregame show and postgame show. We thank him on the postgame show. Victorious celebration for the Cavs. We talked to Eddie Smith, Brandon Dean, Sean Daniels, Albert White, Michael as well. So we thank all of them. Every time I broadcast, I always thank an awful lot of people. But more important, most important, we thank you again for your support of your Lawton-Fort Sill Cavs. We will have basketball next year. I guarantee you. We're not sure where, what, when, but it's going to happen because of the way you people support this great Lawton Cavalry organization. So for the final time, we remind you, the Cavs have won the CBA championship. We win in overtime over Albany, 109 to 107 from Albany, New York. Chris Needham, so long, everybody.